Hello, it's Danny McLaughlin here from the Damn Daniel podcast. You're watching on YouTube. You're ready for the episode. Before we go into that, I want to let you know that there's an additional way that you can support the podcast as well as viewing it on here. It's called Patreon. You probably know about it. It's a little subscription service where you can go on, give us a little bit of money each month, and we can give you additional extras in return. That sounds sleazier than it actually is. It starts at £3 a month, which works out about 10p a day. For that, you get a full extra episode of the DDP, about an hour and a half each week, just to keep you going till the next one comes out. For a little bit more than that, I think it's a fiver, you get the podcast early before anyone else, before the muggles who ain't signed up, yeah? And then there's loads of other stuff that's only going to be exclusive to Patreon. So I don't know if you remember the podcast we did about a couple of months ago where we did Kanye West and Matt Donalds about whether they could save the world. We've got that coming back. We've got one-on-one beat battles where we each pick 10 tunes each and play them against like local musicians and comics. That's loads of fun. It's like a party in here. And we've got watch-alongs as well where we all put a film on. If you're on the Patreon, you can tune in with us with some beers and some snacks and watch along while we commentate nonsense on it. It's all on Patreon, www.patreon.com/DamnDanielPodcast. Join us now, help support. We're growing all the time. We need you. We like it. We like you on board. It's all a big family. Please come with us on this journey and support us. Thanks for listening, and we appreciate y'all.
That'll do, Dean. I think I nailed it there.
Yeah.
Did I come across like a prick?
It's been an hour.
I know it's took an hour to do, Dean, but it's on the YouTube now. You better not put this on.
No, I won't.
Sound.
Promise.
Damn Daniel. Oh, we're off.
Rolling.
What?
Remember him? He came back, the name was...
Yeah. What, The Undertaker?
You
remember he made that his music when he started having a motorbike, The Undertaker. Do you remember that?
It was weird, that rebrand, wasn't it?
It was the worst rebrand of all time.
Because they should have just changed his name as well.
Yeah. To what? Like, called him the American Badass was his like sub name.
Yeah, but you can't go from being like a goth to a mosher like that.
Yeah, no, he proper did. Like, he just stuck on a wallet chain, didn't he? He went, oh, I'm new metal now. Like, it's just like, oh, I listen to Papa Roach.
Yeah.
I've got out of the Undertaking game.
Paul Bearer had to, like, go in his sidecar instead of in his hearse.
Oh, that they should have done that.
Yeah, they should have.
Like, Paul Bearer on his little white face, goggles on, scarf flowing in the wind. That would have been fucking incredible.
Fucking Wallace and Gromit.
Yeah. Mate, the motorbike and sidecar is definitely the funniest mode of transport.
Do you reckon?
Yeah, man, it's hilarious.
Funnier than the penny farthing.
But all right, that has just made me laugh out loud just at the thought of it. Yeah, penny farthing is pretty funny.
We've mentioned it on here before, but do you know what I think the funniest mode of transport is?
What's that?
The pogo stick.
Yeah, pogo stick's up there. Space hopper's got to be in there as well.
Oh, shit, yeah.
It's such an inefficient way to move a space hopper, isn't it? Like, do you remember the first time you used a space hopper? I was expecting it to be so much more fun than it was. Because you're like, you think you're going to like fucking fly on it, and you're just like...
You think you're going to... I don't know whether it's something to do with the title, but you think you're going to hop into space.
I know.
Yeah, you don't go as high as you
Yeah.
Like, I'm going like 3 centimetres in the air. That's not space.
Thing is, if they're truthful with the title and they called it the pavement skimmer, I don't think they'd move as many units.
The gravel shuffler.
That sounds like some mad serial killer. Like, you know, like the canal pusher.
But leaves a spade at the scene of his crimes.
The gravel shuffler. Yeah. Or it sounds like, you know, when people give like sex acts names.
Yeah. Like, a gravel shuffler is not going to be a good one.
No. Well, none of them are good.
Yeah, none of them are romantic.
No. Yeah. Oh, fucking gravel shuffler.
Yeah, I gave her a Norwegian steamboat. What was that? Oh, I led her by the hand down to a lovely meadow. Laid her down and made sweet love to her on the grass.
I fucked her in a car, but it was a Fjord Escort, so it's fine. Norwegian steamboat. Is that a real one?
Nah, I was just like, I took the Cleveland steamboat and changed its location.
Is that poo-poo? It's always
it sounds like poo-poo.
It's always poo-poo, isn't
it? It is, yeah.
I don't want to.
There's loads more names for it than it actually exists, though. These people aren't doing it. They just go on, like, you know, websites and go, here's one.
Well, actually, it's nothing to do with shit. It's still just as weird. Well, not just as weird, but it's weird. So, sexual acts where the girl lies on her back with her top off, The guy stands over her.
Yeah.
Sounds like it's going to be pooped.
Oh.
Then you squat down, dropping your balls to her chest, and you rub your own ejaculate towards her stomach, leaving a trail like, you know, like when boats are in the water.
Oh, right, yeah.
That doesn't sound like a boat. That's nothing like doing that. I wouldn't be like, you know what this reminds me of? Like going on a cruise. Like, what depends are you on about?
Depends what cruise.
Well, that is true. Around Hampstead Heath.
But them old people cruises are popping with diseases.
Yeah, that's true, man. They are fucking lit. You know, like, genuinely, like, I think, like, a really, like, I think a good retirement plan for me, like, you know, if by some, you know, miracle my missus dies before me, because I'm definitely going to go first.
Right.
But say she does, my retirement plan, cruise ship comedian. Because by the time I'm old, all the people on cruises will be all right with me swearing. And then you just sail the seven seas, eating buffets and shagging widows.
Yeah.
What a fucking great life.
I don't think it works out like that.
I think it. If you're the entertainer on the ship, you'll be one of those suave silver foxes.
Because you have to do two different 40s.
We find do crowd work for one of them, mate.
Yeah, I'm here to do two different 60s, if you know what I mean. By the way, I didn't know him, but RIP to Phil Butler.
Yes, RIP. I didn't know him either.
I gigged with him once, but yeah. I didn't really know him. But apparently, he was he's an all right guy.
Yeah, it's always sad to lose a comedian, man, isn't it?
There's a few.
But you know, he wasn't one of them. So.
No, well, I don't know. Maybe some people would think, but I always find it like. The people who've been sad are people who I appreciate. So it's like, I get it.
You can tell by the, like who is upset. Yeah, totally. Like, you're like, oh, there must have been fucking sound. Yeah.
So shout out Phil Butler.
Yeah.
It's all good. Appreciate y'all though.
Appreciate y'all.
Yeah. The true mark of respect.
The sound bed of the guy that was dying on stage. Have you seen that clip?
No, I don't think.
Oh my God. We used to do a segment on here. We can bring it back, actually. Sing it back, bring it back, bring it back to you. Called Punditry, where we'd play someone dying on stage and we'd just chat about
it. I'm well into that.
One of them was someone, I don't recognise him, he looks so different, but it was someone's Chortle student comedian clip. And he was called Rob Mulholland, but it couldn't have been Rob Mulholland because it was like 2008 and Rob Mulholland didn't start comedy till like 2011, apparently.
That is true.
No, I haven't really seen that.
Oh, mate. That was from my false start when I did like 5 gigs and like 2 of them were filmed by Chortle.
Oh, no.
Yeah, brutal, man.
I think I got to the final of that year.
Yeah.
I got 2008.
I got to the semis, I think.
But that was before there was like, I think there was only semis.
Yeah.
And well, then I was final.
I was in them.
I had to go to Leicester.
Yeah.
And only one went through and it was me over, the only other person I remember was Mark Smith.
I don't know if I know him.
You know Mark Smith.
I don't know if I do know Mark
from Nottingham.
I don't know.
Oh, you know Mark Smith, man. How do you not know Mark Smith?
I just don't know if I do.
But he was going under the pseudonym. There he is.
Yeah, I think. I think I'd vaguely. I don't really know him though.
Good guy. Anyway. Good guy. Anyway, but he was going under the pseudonym Winston Smith.
That is not a Caucasian pseudonym.
No, but it's. Thingy, innit? Winston Smith is the main character from 1984.
But
his mob's first thing was like, what is he, Jamaican?
Well, yeah, it sounds Jamaican. That's the thing. It does sound like, before, it does sound too much of a Jamaican name. And also, don't give yourself a pseudonym that is already a famous character. You've made yourself ungoogleable.
Yeah.
Monty Burns.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Yeah, shout out to my man Monty, but what a fucking stupid fucking name. I told him at the time. Like,
yeah, Fred West.
Yeah. That would be like, to be honest, like most people are like hiding Fred West pasts when they get a stage name, innit?
Well, yeah, sometimes.
Sometimes, man.
Chimp with a firearm.
Did you ever consider a stage name?
Nah.
Nah, man, neither.
Do you wish you'd have done it now, though?
Nah.
For the tax.
Yeah, the tax would be nice, but I just don't tell them about the cash gigs anyway.
Ah, right. I declare everything.
No, I do too, obviously.
appreciate your HMRC. We've just been for a little prezzo and it was dog shit. But I was like...
Lower mid-tier.
Yeah, I was hyping it. Yeah. Well, not hyping it, but I was like, this is actually a good chain.
Because I was like, I've never been to a prezzo until then.
But I just genuinely, I didn't want to besmirch the actual company's name. I think that's genuinely just a shit prezzo.
Yeah.
Rest in piss prezzo Broughton Park.
Yeah, man. Like, bring back Jamie's Italian.
And also, it wasn't like the waiters weren't very Italian.
No, one of them was like...
No, they were all... Basically, when you find out where they're all from, it's not a big surprise that there wasn't any petrol. Because they're all in Prezzo.
Yeah.
Fucking slamming out Arabiatas. mine was fine. Mubs had the biggest pizza known to man.
Yeah.
Big old pizza, yeah, that.
No, he just sort of like dislocated his jaw like a fucking python.
Yeah, snake.
Into one go.
But he asked for vegan. I thought they were going to haram you, man.
Yeah, I thought you were getting harammed.
Nah, they're all right, innit? They're all right in Wales.
Yeah. Cause asking for the vegan pepperoni, like, it's the thing I've had a lot with being veggie as well. It's like when someone looks confused when you ask for the veggie option, it's always scary.
She did do that though, didn't she?
Yeah, she had to,
that's what I mean. Like, yeah. I didn't think they were going to haram you on purpose, but I thought they were going to deny you heaven just for a laugh.
Denied heaven for a big pizza.
Fucking deny you heaven like a bouncer on a gay bar in London when straight people turn up. Mate, it's lit there. I walked past there the other week.
Man, it's crazy.
The queue was so big.
Yeah.
The gig's good in there.
Dead good in there, man. Like, it's really good fun. It's a dead good fun to compare because everyone's a tourist, so everyone's from a different country.
Oh,
so
I hate that, though.
I like it, man.
Nah,
leaves you a lot of very surface level jokes that are very a lot of fun for everyone.
Yeah.
Just, I love diving into some racial stereotypes with the crowd. It's great.
I'm very very nationalist when it comes to my comedy audience.
Oh, right, you want them pure?
Yeah, I don't want any tourists, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't want any of that.
If you don't know who Neil Buchanan is, get the fuck out of it.
Oh, I had a good Neil Buchanan joke back in a dizzle. Might bring it back, sing it back. What a joke that was. Do you remember it?
I don't. I barely remember my... I don't remember my old jokes.
Yeah. So basically, it was the fact that Neil Buchanan's a chef now.
Right.
And I went to his restaurant because I thought, at the very least, it's going to look good. Because he's an artist. And when he brought the food over, the waiter brought the food over, it was a fucking disgrace. It's like a big gelatinous mess. And I was like, I want my money back. That is a disgrace. I thought he was arty in here. And he went, hold on. And he put it on the floor and made me stand on a chair. And I looked at it from above and it was a man windsurfing. There you go. There's a little
that's good though.
A little joke from Danny McLaughlin's first ever set.
Yeah.
Little man went, and I did look like it was a man windsurfing like that. Yeah. Oh,
that's good. That did he actually become a chef though?
Nah, he's in a band. Yeah,
a metal band, isn't it?
Yeah. The weirdest transformation: former snooker champion Steve Davis.
Yeah, he's a DJ now.
Techno DJ.
Yeah.
I saw him at a festival when I was off my bollocks. Like I was west. Like my brain wasn't in my body. And I wandered into a tent.
That's in your head, isn't it?
Yeah. My head's part of my body, isn't it? Your head's part of your body.
I don't know.
Yeah.
You just like, said, no, head, body.
Yeah. No, but it's like part of your body.
It's part of your being, but I don't think it's
not part
your
of your
body.
Being. You're being separate to your
No, but it's like
vessel.
Part of your...
just saying, like my physical
If you're playing
body.
Call of Duty, you have a headshot
and
body shot.
Yeah, but like
if you're boxing,
if you found a seven, like if you found like a head, you could be like, oh, I found a bit of the body. Or like if you're looking for a dead person,
if I found,
you
an
found
arm.
A head,
yeah, if I found an
yeah,
arm,
that's a bit of the body. The or, head's a bit of a body as well,
or a thorax. If I found a thorax, I'd be like, that is part of the body,
part of the body of an insect. Who can we have thorax? Yeah,
let's who can we ring?
What this is more a philosophical question.
No,
than
I want.
What about Sid? He's kind of medical, isn't he?
Yeah, let's ring Sid.
Paul Sinner.
Oh, you got his number?
Yeah, I have, but I'm not ringing him. I've been posting for ages.
But like, this is more a philosophical question.
Philosophical. I'm scoffing at it.
I think your head is part of your body. It clearly is. It's part of your body. I get what you mean. You get the differentiation between a head and a body shot. It's still part of your body.
We'll see what Sid says.
I don't care what fucking Sid says.
He's got a qualification in this.
Not in this. Defining the body. That's not what his qualification
animal,
is.
Right?
Hello.
Hi, Sid.
Hey, mate, how are you?
Yeah, you're on the pod.
What? Okay, cool. Give me 1 second to get out of the room.
Are you working?
Yeah.
Oh, Sid, I'm so sorry. I thought you
no,
was
no,
off.
No, absolutely fine.
I thought he was off today.
No. No.
Oh, well, don't worry, this is important, so...
Hey, Rob, you all right?
All right, mate, yeah.
Mubs is here as well.
Hey, Mubs.
Sid? I feel really bad now because it's not important at all. Sorry, man. I genuinely thought you was off this weekend. This ain't the way to go out.
Ask your fucking question.
Don't be swearing.
You have to ask yourself.
Ask the question.
Sid,
this is why he's wrong.
Is the head part of the body? Or are they separate entities?
Yes, the head is part of the body.
Yes!
Oh, no! Yes.
Thank you, Sid. Cheers, mate.
Because Rob said that his brain's in his body.
Rob said, my brain wasn't even in my body. And I was like, well, it's not. It's in your head.
Yeah, but he's my body. He's my physical being. He's my body. You know, my head. The head's part of it. Look, the question's been answered. Let Sid get back to work.
Oh, look at you now. Trying to not let Sid think about what he said.
Nah, don't think, Sid. He's done it. Thanks, mate.
He said that because he's flustered because his boss is in.
No, sorry, Danny. That's one of the easy ones you've never asked me, to be honest.
See, obviously.
But
thank
in
you.
Call of Duty, though, why is there headshots and body shots? Why isn't it all a body shot?
Exactly.
And why in boxing is it like, why do they count the head strikes and the body strikes different?
No, but it's like the body, they're talking about like your sort of chest area.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah,
your brain's not in your chest area.
Yeah, but it's like how like...
Who are you, Krang?
No, but like...
From the Turtles.
No, but you're like how like the United Kingdom's a country, but so's Scotland, right?
Is it?
Yeah, sort of. So, like, you know, your head is part of your body anyway. We've sorted it. Thanks, Sid.
I'm so sorry. I hope I haven't.
I guess that anatomically it's part of the body, and then you can have different. I guess it's like how the top corner is part of the goal, but you talk about it going in the top corner specifically.
Oh, yes. Why have you brought sensible
analogy? Nice
that
one,
was a
Sid.
Good analogy.
Yeah, he's sorted that out now.
But if you found like a dog's head in a field. You wouldn't be like, oh, found a part of a dog's body. You'd be like, there's a dog's head.
But if you were looking for a dead dog, you'd be like, oh, I found part of the body.
I don't know.
Then you'd be like, which bit of the body?
This might be the bit where I just say, let's agree to disagree.
No one's disagreeing.
Oh, no, but you might be on it, because I think so. But then if I said, I found a headless body, then that implies that the normal body includes the head.
Yeah, there you go. Yes.
You've done us.
Yes, Sid.
I'll say, okay, I'll concede.
Many points.
Thanks, Sid. Are you up this weekend?
Yeah, I'm coming up. Are you around Sunday?
I'll be about Sunday, probs, yeah?
Yeah, sounds good. I'll come catch up with you.
All right. Hey,
thanks,
HMU. I'll catch you soon, fun. Sid. Thanks, man.
Take care.
Cheers.
Ooh, well, that didn't work out how someone thought it might.
No, I didn't ring to be right. I rang for the right answer. Shout out, former vet Sid.
Yo, let's chat about dog's heads being he's like going back to the office, is he?
I just imagine him now. He's got to go and put his gloves on and put a fucking gerbil to sleep. No, he doesn't do that. He's a very respected heart surgeon.
Yeah. I had a mate in Brighton who got accused of being a cat killer because there was a cat murderer going around Brighton, and it was like a big story, right? Because all these cats are dying like in like brutal ways that have been like stabbed to death.
Yeah, yeah.
And like they put a photo on the front page of the Brighton Argus where my mate was in the foreground and the cat killer was in the background. So the headline's like cat killer in Brighton. Then the caption really small's like in the background of this photo.
Oh.
So my mate's on all these papers and he's getting death threats, all this shit.
And then he's like, was it you? And he's like, it wasn't me. And then they've gone, oh, it sounds like you. He got the death penalty. They had to kill him 9 times.
But yeah, man, that was mad shit. He proper got caught up in that. But yeah, anyway, Steve Davis is a techno DJ.
Yeah.
That's the point. But yeah, it was a very confronting sight. But like, someone had to explain it to me for like a lot of times. Yeah. I was like, why Steve Davis? Over there, like, in the middle of a trip, seeing Steve Davis behind the decks is a lot to take
in. I knew I would have been like, oh yeah, MC DJ Davis there.
Yeah.
Pat Nevin DJs as well.
Does he? But that makes sense because he was like a cool like music guy. Whereas Steve Davis was like the boring one. And like he puts it down as well. It's like deep German techno. It's really good. Like,
that doesn't sound good. Mate, I don't
German
even like
techno, like Germany's where that shit comes from, innit?
I don't know. Like, originates in Detroit. Oh, that's the original techno. Oh, yeah. Okay.
Put your hands up for Detroit.
Yeah, that was the first one.
I love this city.
It started in black gay clubs in Detroit techno, and house started in Chicago.
Your da hates techno then.
Yeah, mate. It's really anti-da.
Yeah.
It's da repellent.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Oh, well, I was right. It's
you weren't right.
I was.
You can't just fucking trumpet by going like, I think we've all agreed I was right.
Fake news.
Well, you agreed.
Yeah, you agreed. Me and Mubs are in the air.
Why in the footage? Right? We've been filming this whole fucking thing.
Oh, no, the card's corrupted.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, is it now? Is it corrupted? Yeah, I see.
Card's been corrupted. Yeah. Welcome to the
Daniel Podcast
episode.
Loads.
50-something.
So fucking slack. Literally, not one episode I've been on have we had any idea what number it is.
Well, that's good, isn't it?
Yeah. We're just vibing.
Well, vibes in we are. Let's see. 57. Episode 57. I mean, we've Mubs, you're technically the producer. What?
We've done 57. Well, no. Sorry, this is 57.
Yeah.
Mubs.
Fucking hell.
Oh, I'm not with it, me.
Jesus Christ, man.
Mubs, doesn't
he's
even
had, he's had so much gluten.
Is that pizza, bro? It's fucking off.
Yeah, mate. You can just feel the gates closing on you because you had that pepperoni.
It looked like the challenge was...
Fucking may as well keep your shoes on now. You ain't getting in. You ain't getting in.
That pizza did look like you should have won a t-shirt for finishing it.
They just took a virgin off you. Every slice of that pizza you had, they took a virgin off you.
What do you still like? Did she just go shag someone and then come back?
No. She's just
removed
elsewhere. I think.
Yeah. Fair enough.
I don't know. I don't really want
to
comment.
She's gone to Danny because he didn't have pepperoni, did he?
Nah, I don't want that.
You had chicken, didn't you?
Yeah, I did have chicken, but I also don't want that. That's not my flex, really.
Yeah.
No one wants that, though. No, but anyway, sounds terrible.
Yeah, it really, really, really does.
So, how have you been, Mubs? Because you've not been... What's weird is, like, you do your work at home with your top on, and then your top off, sorry. And then when you're here, you wear coats indoors.
Yeah.
It's really...
You come in here like you're on a fucking Arctic expedition. Sat at home like he's in Marbella.
Mate, it's usually colder in here, though.
Is it, though?
Yeah. I come in here in T-shirts sometimes, and then I've got to put my hoodie on.
Oh, no. So why didn't you... I just don't understand. Because coat is like a step up, isn't it, from the hoodie?
I'd say this is a jacket, me... You want to see my coat? Wait till it's winter. I'll bring
Let me ring through. Sid, see if a jacket's a coat. Imagine.
Oh, mate, please ring him back. Please interrupt his work again. Just play, mate, you've got another one. Is a jacket a coat?
No, but he'll be, because he's a vet, he'll be like, nah, a coat is fur, innit?
Yeah. How glossy is this jacket?
Oh, mate, we can't just be ringing people asking these questions.
No, not people, just Sid.
Just
over and over again. See how many times before he tells us to fuck off.
No, because they want to get him the sack. He's a good guy.
Yeah. You can't get the sack just for answering philosophical questions on the
clock. Well, you might be able to get the sack for answering the phone. He might not even be allowed his Footlocker. I wasn't even allowed my phone on the shop floor.
Do you reckon if he's like in surgery, he's had to take his like gloves and
that's what I mean. That's what I'm saying.
Just pulled his hand out of a cow to answer.
Hello, you're on the Damn Daniel Podcast.
Oh, sorry, Sid.
It's all good. Appreciate y'all, though.
Oh, thank you. That was Sid's reply. What have you been doing, Mubs?
Now just work, football, gym.
Been graveyard.
You live, innit?
Been graveyard.
Graveyard shifts. Yeah, you know that late night.
That's Mubs' code.
Oh, yeah.
For 2020. When he goes
going
graveyard.
Yeah, all right, yeah. Weird. Makes you sound like a fucking proper nonce. It's like really weird. Hanging around graveyard is odd behaviour.
It's not nonce behaviour, though.
It's not the actual dead
nonce. You know what I mean?
Well, no, because a lot of the people in graveyard are old, innit? So.
Yeah, but I mean, like a necrophile. Like that.
Yeah, but that's not. You can't. Nonce. Mate.
It's a type of nonce to me.
I don't think. Well, it's not, is it?
It's nonce adjacent.
I don't know if it is.
It's noncey.
It's not.
I know what you mean, Ron, but yeah, it's not.
But
not
Rig Sid. Rig Sid.
Sid. It's a necrophile, a nonce.
No.
I know what you mean. It wasn't the technical term. I was just trying
but
to
I've
not.
Already asked
I was
him trying about to that. Not. That's the mad thing. I rang Sid and went, if you fuck a puppy, are you a dog nonce? Like. I've already interrupted. That was his first verbal warning.
Imagine if he's in a disciplinary and they're just playing clips of this podcast.
Get the views up.
Just HR. Get the listens. Get on the Patreon, HR. If you're watching this, if you're firing our boy Sid, you owe us a fucking Patreon.
Get some chew gummies.
We'll send you a bag HR, if you don't fire him.
Get on the Patreon because Sid might have to cancel his now. Times are tough.
Oh, fuck.
What do you want to talk about?
I can't remember
what I was going to say. I feel like I want to talk about the fuck's gone on with Alec Baldwin, but
well, I know, man. This is like the problem.
Well, that's going to be old news by the time this comes out.
Who gives a shit, man? Like, as we record, this has just happened. Like, I don't think any of us have actually read the story beyond the headlines.
He shot a poor woman,
which is obviously horrible, but like, he shot her with a prop gun. Didn't he? Why are they loading prop guns? That's what I don't understand. Why is there a live bullet anywhere near a prop gun?
Is a prop gun not just like firing blanks?
Well, you think, just don't put any bullets in it. Like,
I think it's fair to everyone involved that we get the actual story.
Yeah, that's probably
true.
Instead
of speculating on this.
No, fuck it. I think speculate wildly with as few facts as possible.
I think he shot her with a phaser gun and he forgot to put it on stun.
He's hit her with a double-ended lightsaber.
It was on kill instead of stun in Star Trek. That's what it was.
So yeah, it was a prop gun. It was filled with blanks.
Yeah.
But all the
blanks can kill someone if they're close enough, so maybe it was that.
So I've seen in Bruges, innit, where the guy, he gets shot in the eye with a blank.
Yeah.
But could you kill someone with it?
I think so.
Well,
it doesn't say much about it in the article, innit?
Yeah, there's not going to be a lot of news coming out yet.
RIP that poor woman, man, who goes to work and ends up getting killed by fucking...
Yeah.
South Park were right. The Team America.
Yeah.
Kim Jong-il. Which is the one now?
Now's or nothing.
So ill. It was Kim Jong Il.
Yeah, ill was the papa. Yeah, but he's madman. Like you know the film's about someone getting accidentally shot.
What the?
The Alec Baldwin film that he's making.
So, that's weird. If that's me, I'm thinking that's publicity.
Yeah, if someone just got shot in the leg, I'd agree with you. But I think dying is a bit too far. I think they've taken it to... If it is publicity, they've gone too far with it.
Yeah, but I genuinely think, like, these bigwigs in Hollywood and that, they don't give a shit about, like, some poor woman who's a costume designer.
Yeah, no, like, I believe that.
Damage.
I believe that
it's
they
a
might
murky
well be...
world.
I believe that they might well be fucking delighted, some of the lizard psychopaths who...
Yeah, maybe it's
but
like...
But I don't think that
it...
That's a plan. And how are you going to go, we'll put one bullet in Alec Baldwin's gun and get him to point it at the
but
costume
the thing
designer?
Is, why is he pointing it at the costume?
I know, why is he pointing at anyone? You shouldn't point guns at anyone, innit?
I mean, if it was like his co-star, like what happened to Brandon Lee.
Yeah, but maybe he's just got it on this shot and she's just stood around behind the camera. You know, like he's on set.
Oh, right.
You know what I mean? It could just be a stray.
So weird.
It's really fucking weird.
What's proper grim is she's proper come up. Like she grew up on a Soviet base under the Arctic Circle and she's working on Hollywood films now.
RIP. What a poor woman, man.
Yeah,
just going to work.
It's fucking horrid, that, man. Like,
I don't want to even talk about it. It makes me sick. Yeah.
Another thing it says here is real firearms are often used in filming and loaded with blanks.
Yeah.
So,
right. Maybe someone's fucked up and put a real bullet in, like not put the right ammo in. But it's fucked. Like, how does that happen though? You've got to have like weapons experts and shit, surely. I don't know. It's America, innit?
I looked at the Twitter and some guy was like, well, this is why you shouldn't use guns in films. And I was like, nah.
Like, in films, you can't make films without guns. Like, you can't ban guns in films because Alec Baldwin's fucked up.
Yeah. Well, it's probably not even him.
It's probably not him.
Like, I feel sorry for him as well.
Yeah. It's props department who's fucked up, innit? Like, whoever's done that. But yeah, like, it's, you know, that isn't the thing. Like, that's like, it's the internet, innit? There's always someone who hilariously misses the point and, like, is like, getting angry at totally the wrong fucking thing.
Yeah,
guns in movies like isn't going anywhere. We're not stopping that. Stop putting bullets in them. Just pretend, you know. Yeah, you might have thought that. Yeah, pyown! Bang, 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 bang.
Pyown.
Yeah.
He should have said pyown. Can you get that BBC list of the 100 greatest TV shows of this century up? I just want to see Christ. Rob lose it here.
Mate, like this is so annoying because I know you're just lighting the touch paper, yeah. But like, you know it's going to happen.
Yeah, that's why I'm lighting it.
I know.
I'm not Alec Baldwin. I know exactly what I'm doing.
Yeah, I've got it up.
Oh, man.
So what are we... Are you going straight from the top?
So this is top TV shows of the last 100 years, isn't it?
No.
Of this century.
This century.
Right.
That's
right.
Why Sopranos in it.
Right.
Because
right,
people
right.
were kicking off going, where's Sopranos? It's the best one. It's 90s. Like 99,
yeah,
mate.
Yeah, yeah.
Or 90, it might even be 98.
All right.
So I don't want you to go down. One is obvious though. Why would have guessed one?
Yeah. The Wire.
Have you got it? Have you got the list?
Yeah, I've got it. Yeah, The Wire is first.
Yeah. There you go. Yeah, yeah.
And what's two?
Mad Men.
That is so good, Mad Men.
I don't rate it. I don't like it, but I get that it's, you know,
it's
why
fucking
people like.
Brilliant.
I didn't enjoy it, but I see what other people
loved
did.
It. Loved it.
Number three is Breaking Bad.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Did you say that's the third best?
I'm not.
I would put it right there.
I feel like you about the way you feel about Mad
exactly,
Men. Like,
yeah.
I'm not mad that it's there. It's obviously good, but it wasn't for me. I didn't really.
I loved it though. I thought it was incredible. Breaking Bad. Like.
Did you see it before you saw Mad Men?
Yeah,
that's what I mean. I often think it matters which one you, because I saw Mad Men before Breaking Bad,
right?
And
right,
I often
right.
think it's which one you saw first, and
yeah,
you're like, oh,
maybe.
And then everything's just like,
yeah,
you're judging that one on that one. Then
sure, I just wasn't that into in Mad Men. I didn't know who, because like everyone's a cunt in it. It was like, I found it a bit like, I didn't have anyone to root for,
yeah.
And no one was getting killed. So at least on like programs like The Wire or Breaking Bad, when someone's a prick, you can be like, I can't wait to see them get shot.
Yeah,
like, on Mad Men, they just carry on getting richer.
So cool,
so it's just,
though.
Yeah, and like there's loads of things that are great.
Made me want to smoke and drink whiskey and
yeah.
I think slap I was abroad.
I think I was also giving up all of those things at that time.
Right, yeah,
I was stopping smoking and drinking and like, you know, sexually harassing.
Imagine if it was just about like your dad's in the pub talking about immigration.
Yeah. Well, that's the real day drinkers, isn't it?
No, that's the real madmen. That's what I'm talking about. Just there go, fuck it, oh, I'm so fuming.
Yeah. And they get a free house.
They've all got flat screens.
Yeah,
next week on Mad Men.
Come and get my Ferrari.
Next week on Mad Men, Don Draper goes to Dover to give him a real piece of his mind.
Penny walks into traffic to throw shit at a car.
Here's the one. Just watch Rob's face now. What's fourth?
It's called Fleabag. Don't even know the show.
Right, where's... is Curb Your Enthusiasm in it?
Oh, my God. Right. It's... Fourth best show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you
where?
Want to tell you the number?
Where?
21.
Fuck off! Fuck off!
21st.
Just... Fucking Fleabag 4.
Bro, they put Atlanta over that. Atlanta's good, but I don't think it's better than
fucking
Curb.
Fucking Fleabag 4, like... fucking hate Fleabag so fucking much. It's just posh woman's wank fantasy. It is one of the least funny things I've ever fucking seen in my life.
Is it as funny as a bag of fleas?
Mate, there's more amusement to be had there. Fleas organise circuses that are very entertaining.
Flea circus would have been better than Fleabag.
Way more entertaining than
what
Fleabag.
Else? Flea market?
Yeah, that's great. Been, I love a flea market.
Flea from Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Way more interesting.
He's got
play
a sock.
Me some slap
got
bass.
A sock on his cock.
Brilliant.
Yeah, that's it.
Rather than just a fucking posh woman going, oh, I fancy a vicar and making no jokes.
Is that what it is?
Yeah, man, it's so boring. There's no jokes in it. It's not funny. And it's just an aristocrat.
Yeah, but Rob, she came from adversity. She went to the Edinburgh Festival in 2012 and got a 3-star review.
Yeah, I know. She had it really hard. That
didn't we all?
She's fucking landed gentry as well. She's like the daughter of like an aristocrat. Like, you know, owns half a fucking Surrey.
Okay.
And like,
your
so
mate
shit.
Was the daughter of an aristocrat. Yeah. The one that was the cat killer. Yeah. Did he get away with that?
He got away with it, yeah. He got off scot-free. I bet they caught the actual cat killer and he was,
I googled him, he looks like Voldemort.
Who, the cat killer?
Yeah. With a nose.
Yeah.
They got him, but he was feline low for a while. But they got him. Stop going away, because that was quite good. When you go away, it just devalues everything I'm doing here when I'm trying to think of puns on my own podcast. It can't be like you. Where's the support? Well, like, where's the support?
I can't laugh at a pun because it doesn't do that to me.
So you should know, be like, laugh. Oh, fair enough. I appreciate y'all.
All right.
No.
Oh, no. That's
yeah, all right. I'll do that.
Yeah, next time. Shit.
I'm still thinking of cat puns, me.
Yeah. But fucking. It does mean. Yeah, it does mean.
You're pissed about that, man.
Mate, because what I wasn't is I don't like. Look, I get it's not for me, and I'm happy for the people that enjoy it. Lovely, you've got a thing. But let's not fucking pretend it is the fourth best program of this. No, fucking that's what's. Century.
Yeah, we're not saying it. I've not seen it, but I'm not saying it's shit.
I am, but like, well, you've but seen like it. That's subjective, and it's subjective as well. Like, other people will enjoy it for that, but like, the problem is that is definitely because it's a BBC list. It's just all the rich white women at the BBC making this list. Going, Fleabag spoke to me. 206
TV experts from 43 countries.
TV experts,
43 countries.
Well,
though.
We asked a medical expert before about
yeah
and he got
TV
it wrong.
Experts,
that, you were all right with that.
TV and medicine are very different fields, man. TV
fucking
and medicine are very different fields.
Fucking Mops has done you there, lad.
206 people were
yeah, 206 old. Fucking tell TV you what we'll producers. Do
we'll go, have you got the 100?
Yeah,
you,
yeah, the full list.
Let's go from 100 down and we'll see.
100 up.
No, sorry, 100 yeah. up. Well, it's down, isn't it?
Well, the list actually starts.
If you go 100
one,
up.
The list starts.
Yeah, but
one.
One's the top on this.
No, but if you count, you count in.
You're counting down, but yeah. That's up the list.
Right, well. 100 down.
Ring Sid.
Still works. What's 100?
100 is the Queen's Gambit.
That was better than Fleabag.
Is that the chess
I reckon.
One?
Yeah, that was quite.
I haven't seen it, but like, it's great. Good, yeah.
I imagine it's better than Fleabag. Although it's got that guy in there, we were talking about him the other day, that Thomas Brody Sangster. Talking about it with some friends, and they were saying, like, it's the guy from Love Actually who was like Liam Neeson's kid, and he's in Game of Thrones.
Oh, right,
but
yeah.
Now he's old,
him.
But
yeah,
he still looks dead young.
Yeah, he does.
And those
yeah.
young people, when they get old, it just looks like their face has been put through an app.
I know what you mean.
You know what I mean?
It's not quite right. It's a bit uncanny valley.
There's a comedian who looks like that and he's not aged well. Yeah. I don't want to name him. Let's call him Michael Blue. Mike Blue. It's fine. And do you know what I mean?
No.
Let's call him Silk Blue. That might be better. Glossy Blue. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Right, I've got you.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Have you seen him recently?
Yeah.
Looks like he's been face apped. Looks like he's drank from the wrong cup in Indiana Jones, just dead quick, just aged dead quick, like overnight though.
Mate, like lockdown did bad for a lot of people, man. I've met a few people.
No, it's not
there.
That he's, it's just that, it's not him or any of his life. It's because those people.
Yeah, I think, if you look like a child, then it's. Yeah.
I think a friend of ours is going to have it tough in 20 years because he looks young.
Who's that?
I don't want to say his name, he's a nice guy.
Yeah.
You know him better than me.
Yeah.
You've worked with him for a while.
Oh yeah,
on a thing.
Yeah,
that you'd get from the Toby Carvery.
Right, I'm with you. I know what you mean. Yeah,
yeah,
yeah, yeah, maybe
because he's got such a pretty boy, young face.
Yeah,
I'm not saying now he still looks great, but I mean, amazing. Like when he's 60, he might look weird.
His genetics though are like so ridiculous. I can see him just becoming like a fucking silver fox, just
like me. That's what I'm gonna be like. Yeah, if I lose a stone, mate, it's over for your bitches.
Yeah. Are you gonna though?
Yeah, I reckon.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, worry and sadness will get me there. yes. Yeah,
I'm on that depression diet.
Yeah, that's essentially it. Yeah. I'm only eating black dogs. I'm on the black dog diet. What's 99?
Steven's Universe. That was on Cartoon Network. That
right, not seen it.
Number 98, Crazy Ex-Girlfriend.
Oh, that's fucking shit.
No,
it's a fucking musical. I hate it. It's so bad.
97, Hannibal. I've seen a bit of that.
That's all right.
Yeah.
It's not.
Yeah, but we're at 97, so you know, it's going to be like all right, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, Fleabag's probably all right. Yeah.
I mean, I've already seen one like 10 higher up the list, which I think Hannibal's better than, but
what's
we'll get
that?
To that later. Oh, I was going to say, How I Met Your Mother.
How I Met Your Mother is fucking 86. Dog shit.
Yeah, it's shit, isn't it?
Fucking shit. Up. Absolutely terrible, terrible program that has aged awfully. What a shit program. Mm.
Number 96 is something called Catastrophe.
I've heard of that.
No.
I've heard of it. I haven't seen it. Oh, that's with Sharon Hogan and Rob Delaney.
Oh, okay. Oh,
it's like Knocked Up, but with them two.
They won't let me out.
Yeah.
Number 95, Luther.
I'm knocked up.
What?
Luther.
Luther is fucking brilliant.
Yeah, he's 95th.
There's no way that Flea Dog is better than Luther, mate. No better way.
You said it like Luther, like scrubbing yourself.
Yeah,
in.
Yeah, because I feel dirty because of that list.
Do you reckon Superman washes himself with a Lex Luthor?
See, it's not nice, is it?
I enjoyed it. No.
What else?
So 94, that's Louis. That was that comedian.
Yeah, Louis's better than Fleabag.
Is it?
Yeah, but like, obviously you're not allowed to have that. Yeah,
he wanked in a plant pot. So
no, the plant pot wasn't him. The plant pot was Epstein.
Oh, was it?
The plant pot story is not him. No, no.
Oh, right.
Like, he did a lot of similar stuff. I don't know why I'm fighting this battle. It's like he was jizzing somewhere. It doesn't really matter if it was in a plant pot or not. But yeah, I don't think the plant pot was him.
Right.
Mate, what's mad is Always Sunny is number 90.
Oh, get fucked. Yeah, get to fuck.
Is that good?
It's Always Sunny is like an amazing sitcom. Really good, it's incredible. Really the last series was shit, but they've had like 13 seasons of it being fucking fire.
And yeah, but then character development
fucking
as well.
Cumbo Wrexham, so he can suck his mum.
Way better than Fleabag, it's Always Sunny.
Right, okay.
Way better.
All right then, I'll tell you what we'll do. Yeah. You've seen Fleabag.
Yeah.
We'll count down.
Yeah.
And I just want a yes or no.
Is it better than Fleabag or not? Okay. All right. And if I've not seen it, I'm saying yes, it's better than Fleabag.
No, you have to say don't know.
Right.
All right. This one, number 93, is called Treme.
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 It's good. It's
good shampoo.
It's the guy from that. Yeah. It's the guy from The Wire. It's about Katrina after the hurricane.
Right. Okay.
Wendell
it sounds
Pierce,
better than Fleabag, which Wendell, is just about a posh
well,
woman
anything that,
getting bummed.
Anything that Wendell Pierce is in is going to be better than Fleabag.
Yeah. Fern Brady made such a good point about Fleabag. She was like, if that was about a woman, like a working class woman, everyone would be like, oh, this is fucking gross, lowbrow, nothing. But because it's a posh woman getting bummed in it, they're like, oh, she's so brave.
Yeah.
You know? Fuck off.
Adversity.
Yeah.
Go on.
Show me a hero.
No idea.
That was only on for 1 year, it looks like.
Right.
Westworld.
That was shit. Fucking hated Westworld.
Better than Fleabag.
Better than Fleabag.
I'm calling it a draw.
Right.
Okay. And then, we said Always Sunny. We've done that one. Dexter.
Better than Fleabag. It's got to be. It's great.
I've not seen it, but loads of people fucking love it. Yeah.
The OA.
The OA. Was that... Oh, what was that?
Let's keep this a snappy segment, guys.
Yeah. Don't know. We're doing 100.
Yeah, fuck it. Well, that's why it's going to be... Yeah, well, yeah, if you worry up. Less than a second, 2 minutes.
All right, let's do it. The Comeback.
No idea.
How I Met Your Mother.
Shit.
Narcos.
Right, you need
better
to say...
Better than Fleabag.
You need to say... So when you say shit, does that mean Fleabag's better?
Yeah. Well, right.
So this is the thing. This is what we're trying
Fleabag
to ascertain.
Fleabag is also shit.
Yeah, exactly.
Right. Okay.
I'm not bothered what's shit and what's not. I want to know what's better than Fleabag.
Right. I'll just say better or worse.
Yeah, or don't know.
Right.
They're the three options.
Okay.
Go.
All right, there's two tied for 84, so Narcos and Normal People.
Not seen Normal People, but Narcos is way better than Fleabag.
Yep. Insecure?
No idea.
Big Little Lies?
Don't know.
OJ Made in America?
Way better than Fleabag.
House?
Better than Fleabag.
Mindhunter?
Don't know.
Better than Fleabag's got to be. It's phenomenal.
The Killing, in brackets, it says Denmark.
Right, better so the original, so probably better than Fleabag.
Way better than Fleabag. That was the original Scandi.
Yeah.
Right, yeah, when everyone got dead into them.
Yeah, that lot. And then they wanted their Brexit model.
Yeah.
American Crime Story.
Don't know.
Rick and Morty.
Yeah, better than Fleabag, though.
Yeah. Babylon Berlin.
No idea.
Utopia.
No idea.
Right, Planet Earth.
Don't know. Oh, no, the D'Ambra. Way better.
Yeah.
How's that at 50? What the fuck? It's one of the most mind-blowing programs ever fucking made.
And it's got actual fleas in it.
Yeah.
There's not one flea in Fleabag.
Mate, if there was a flea...
It's just bags.
On Attenborough, you'd skip past it pretty fucking quick, though. Well, oh, there's a flea. Now back to, killer whales fucking each other.
If Fleabag...
Better than a posh woman getting shagged, didn't it? Watching a whale do it.
I can't believe that.
If Fleabag was about tired fleas and their eyes...
Right, 72 Gilmore Girls.
Sorry, was that at 73?
73, bro. I thought it'd be number one.
That is absurd. They spend like 9 months waiting for a snow leopard.
Yeah. We're spending like 9 months on this segment. And now
we're Mubs, only in the fucking 70s.
And now Mubs is labouring to get through the 60s.
Did you do Gilmore Girls?
I don't know, but I'm going to say draw.
All right. Enlightened.
Don't know.
Battlestar Galactica.
Better than Fleabag.
It's got to be. Yeah.
24.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I wish I'd have seen, Fleabag so I could play this game.
Stranger Things.
No, I don't know. No, didn't watch it.
All right, you like this one. RuPaul's Drag Race.
Oh, that's better than Fleabag.
Mayor of Easttown.
Apparently, that's really good, that.
Orange is the New Black.
That's great, better than Fleabag.
It's all right.
The animals, trapped till the cage is full. It's better than Fleabag.
Better than Fleabag.
Number 64 is Detectorists.
Oh, yeah.
Was that Mackenzie Crook?
Yeah, Mackenzie Crook.
And the guy who runs the gigs in Leeds.
Yeah.
Toby Jones.
Yeah. I only watched like one episode, better than Fleabag.
Right.
Next one is Pose.
Better than Fleabag. Yeah. It's got to be. Pose is phenomenal.
I thought you gave it a little.
Mate, Pose little drag is flick. Fucking brilliant.
The Good Place.
I didn't like Good Place. I'm going to call that a draw.
All right, 61. Avatar, The Last Airbender. So that's like anime, isn't it?
Yeah, manga.
Yeah, manga.
We'll say worse, fuck it. Yeah. Because it's for virgin.
The Last Airbender didn't have to struggle through adversity and only get a 3-star review at the Edinburgh Fringe.
Yeah. It sounds like such a teenage insult, though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Fucking Airbender.
Yeah. It's like when Freddie Mercury plays air guitar. Yeah.
Strutting around doing this.
That's good, that.
Thanks, man. Yeah, cheers.
Number 60, House of Cards.
Oh, that was great.
Way better. But again, more problematic.
Yeah.
But, you know.
Well, there's a lot of way betters, isn't there?
Yeah, man.
59, The Underground Railroad.
Don't know.
Apparently that's really good. That's new. It's on Amazon.
Yeah, just don't this know. One, yeah. 58 is Dark. Don't know what that is.
Don't know.
No. The Young Pope.
Don't know.
Oh, that was Jude Law.
Ooh, I'm going to be sick.
What is he good for?
Big Bang Theory is 56.
Oh, get
Big Bang
fuck.
Theory is rated higher than Always Sunny.
That's so insulting. Like, Big Bang Theory is... it's a thick person's idea of a clever show.
Sorry, yeah, I was just doing the canned laughter.
Yeah, it's insane. Like, it is so shit. Like,
let's... hold on. I wonder if... if we can get this to work... Yeah. Have you heard the jokes without the kind of laughter?
Yeah, mate, it is brutal. It's so brutal in it. It just lays it out so stark.
Let's see if we can play a little bit. Are.
Mate, it's like, it just...
I can't believe it's that
better
high.
Than Always Sunny. It's Always Sunny is so innovative and so funny. It's just funny. Like, it's clever. It's
like a unique take on things, isn't it?
100%.
They don't even impact. Yeah.
Nothing makes beer taste better than cool, clear Rocky Mountains spring water. Where are the Rocky Mountains anyway?
Philadelphia.
Really? I thought they were out west someplace.
Think about it, Raj. Where did the movie Rocky take place?
Philadelphia. Okay, now I get it.
So, this is the plan. From now on, we're just going to hide out in here to avoid the shamey.
I'm very comfortable here. Penny, dear, why don't you shoot another silver bullet my way?
Get one yourself.
Ooh, somebody's been taking bitchy pills.
Bitchy pills? God, he's an ass when he drinks.
Well, he's an ass when he doesn't. You just don't hear it.
I think we need to start entertaining the possibility that...
The first comment is, without the laugh track, it just sounds like people fighting.
I mean, it's
just someone's put if Big Bang Theory was filmed in front of a live audience.
I think it is, though. I think it's just filmed in front of a live audience of fucking morons. You know, they just get morons in and get them excited.
You know, yeah, that's what American TV is like, isn't it? Yeah. They have someone running across.
Exactly. It's just that environment. Yeah. Like, so, you know, I don't think like canned laughter is really as much of a thing as people think it is. It's just they get a studio full of excited idiots and they do actually laugh like that at nothing. Like, you know, you must have, Danny, you've seen people crush with nothing. You know, you've seen like stand-ups like do really well just on energy when you know, there's no actual jokes.
And sometimes awesome.
Yeah.
where are we up to?
So we're on 55 right now.
Fucking hell.
Almost
not even halfway.
Hey, I'm still pissed about one just slightly ahead, but number 55 is The Shield.
Oh, that's my, like
Michael Chiklis.
Michael Chiklis. Yeah.
I haven't watched that yet, but I've been saving it because it's meant to be amazing. So, like, better, I'm saying better than Fleabag.
Happy Valley.
Never seen it.
I don't know.
Is that Raquel from Coronation Street? I think it is.
I don't know.
Sarah Lancashire.
54 is. 53, Call My Agent.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, this one I'm a bit gutted about. 52, This Is England. And they like put all three of them
on.
So 88.
All three of those series could be like in the top 20. Definitely.
Yeah, I'd agree
definitely.
With that. I'd agree with
they're
that.
They're amazing.
They're really
like,
good.
They're fucking incredible. I love This Is England. I love the whole thing.
We didn't need it. Didn't need them all.
Didn't need them all, I'm sure, yeah. But like some of them were fucking amazing.
Mm.
Small Axe.
Don't know.
Halt and Catch Fire.
Don't know.
The Bureau.
Not seeing it.
Inside Number 9.
Oh, yeah.
Heard of that.
Yeah, it's not for me. It's like little fucking plays, but I think they're very, very well done. So better than Fleabag.
Yeah.
Grey's Anatomy.
It's the same.
Right.
Homeland.
That's got to be better than Fleabag.
Yeah, like
right.
First series, anyway.
The Good Fight.
Oh, awesome. The Good Fight is way better than Fleabag. The Good Fight is proper good, like
fighting.
Almost shit telly. It's about like lawyers.
Right.
And it's like a drama about lawyers.
Yeah.
But it's like fucking really watchable telly. I really like the
better
Good Fight.
Better than Fleabag then.
Better than Fleabag.
Okay.
So we got Community.
Oh no, The Good Fight is the Good Wife spin-off, which wasn't quite as good. No,
still better than Fleabag.
Still better than Fleabag.
Was that on the list? I think I might have seen The Good Wife.
Anyway, should be further up than The Good Fight.
44 was Community.
Oh, way better than Fleabag.
Gambino. 43, Money Heist.
Better than Fleabag. It's the Spanish one.
Peep Show.
Better than Fleabag. Yeah.
It's got to be better than Fleabag. Just for when he had the dog. Oh. Better than Fleabag.
Mate, like the whole... The whole thing of it is so much like it was so innovative. It's fucking hilarious. It's an amazing sitcom.
Yeah.
Like,
Schitt's Creek.
Oh, I didn't rate it, to be honest, but still better than Fleabag.
Yeah.
Borgen, is that how you say that?
Yeah, Borgen, better than Fleabag.
The US Office.
Better. Way better. That's mad that that's that low.
That's 39.
Yeah.
That's
crazy. The UK Office is like 9, I think.
Yeah. Is it? 38, The Handmaid's Tale.
Didn't see it, but my missus loved it.
It's probably better than Fleabag.
Probably better than Fleabag.
Right, there's 2 for 36. Downton Abbey's the first one, and Band of Brothers is the second one.
They've both got to be better than Fleabag.
Band of Brothers definitely is. Band of Brothers is amazing.
Mate, Downton can't be shit, just how, like, it's, there's a film and that.
There's a film, there's shit films, though.
I know, but yeah, I just feel like, you know, like I was saying about... Phil Butler when he died, like the people who say it's good,
sure,
I then believe.
Yeah. I'm willing to put it as better than Fleabag. I'm fine with it. I'm not going to fight you on it.
So 35, we've got Fargo.
Yeah.
It's got to be better than Fleabag. Yeah. So good.
The Bridge.
Better than Fleabag.
Ah, here we go.
The Norwegian one, though.
The Good Wife is 33.
There you go. Better. Way better.
Arrested Development.
Way better.
Oh, it's got to be better than Fleabag.
Well, the first three series, like... Series 5 is one of the worst things I've ever fucking seen.
Oh, is it? I've not seen it.
There's just no jokes. It's all plot. Like, it's just really shit. But
That's a good show, that.
But the first two series are 10 out of 10.
Yeah.
Perfect. Plus they, and then series 3 is a 9 out of 10.
I invent the May and Egg.
Yeah, man. There's so much...
Is that from that show?
Yeah.
There's so much amazing, brilliant stuff in Arrested Development. Like, it's... Genuinely, I think the first two series are like up there with any sitcom ever.
But is it better than Fleabag?
Yes.
Okay.
Hands down. Right, 31, True Detective.
It's gotta be.
Yeah. Although I thought I didn't like how it panned out, but it was a fucking gripping watch.
Yeah.
I thought the last episode was stupid.
Have you heard of Girls?
I've
heard of Girls, mate.
Fuck off.
Loads of them.
That's American Fleabag. That
is American Fleabag. Yeah,
yeah.
That's Fleabag.
Flea sack. Flea trash
flea
bag.
Fanny pack.
29, Parks and Rec.
Oh, that's fire. Yeah.
Way better.
Friday Night Lights.
Oh, so fire.
Line of Duty.
It's gotta be.
It's gotta be
better than Fleabag.
Right, 26 is Watchmen. I thought that'd be better than 26.
I haven't seen the TV show.
Apparently it's good though.
25 is Sherlock.
It's gotta be better. It's better. Is it? Yeah.
Good.
24 is Veep.
Oh yeah, yeah. That's the guys that did the thick of it.
Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Yeah, she's amazing. Anderson. I haven't actually watched it, but all the people in here are incredible. So I bet it's dead good. Is that Armando Iannucci?
Do you reckon it's better than?
I'm gonna say better than Fleabag.
Yep. All right. 23 is Better Call Saul.
Better than Fleabag.
Black Mirror.
Better.
21, Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Mate, that is so upsetting.
Better than Fleabag.
So upsetting. That, like, it's again, one of the best sitcoms ever.
Mm. I can't wait till you hear number six, by the way.
Number 20 is The Thick of It.
Amazing. Better than Fleabag.
19, Lost.
Yeah, I didn't rate it, but still, better.
Deadwood.
Better, it's got to be. That should be top 10.
Mm. Oh, you would just say so?
Yeah, it's so good.
30 Rock, that's all right. I don't know about 17.
Better though, innit?
Mm.
16, The Crown.
Yeah, again, not for me. I don't like that Tory propaganda, but better.
15, we've got Chernobyl.
Way better. Chernobyl was amazing.
I didn't see it.
Oh, it's good. It's only like 4 episodes.
Is it?
Yeah, it's good.
Okay. 14 is Atlanta, which they're making a new season of right now.
Yeah, I haven't watched it because my girlfriend's been trying to make me watch it for ages.
Ah, right.
It's all right. I think everyone overrates it, but it's good. Like, you find it entertaining. yeah, better than Fleabag. Right, 13, mate. It's Twin Peaks, The Return.
I haven't watched
Didn't
it.
Didn't see it.
Didn't, right, we'll call that an N/A.
Yeah. Number 12, 6 Feet Under.
Better.
11, fuck this show, man. BoJack Horseman, that is shit.
You are an idiot. BoJack Horseman is amazing.
Nah, it's crazy.
You've never been truly depressed, mother.
Yeah. You've never been a depressed man who works in entertainment.
With a horse's head.
Yeah. Like, it was just watching my fucking grim potential future.
BoJack. Oh, really? I've not seen it.
It's genuinely amazing. I think, like, it's a fucking stunning piece. It's amazing.
To be fair to the show, I only gave the first 2 episodes a try.
Right, then you don't know what you're fucking talking about, man. Yeah. It's amazing. It's genuinely, like, incredible.
By the way, since we've done this, how many notable omissions have you thought of?
Oh, so far? I haven't thought of any.
I've just been thinking.
Oh, yeah.
Right, number 10, Succession.
Yeah, yeah, that's amazing. Way better.
Way better. The UK Office.
Way better.
Right, we're in top 10. So number 8 is The Americans.
The Americans?
Yeah.
Literally never heard of it.
Must be good.
Well, I don't know, judging by some of the other things on this.
That was the joke.
Well, I missed it.
Yeah, set during the height of the Cold War. Actually looks pretty cool from the pictures.
All right.
Number 7 is The Leftovers.
Again, I've not heard of that.
Must be good.
Number 6, I May Destroy You.
Yeah.
And then number 5.
That's definitely there, like, for no other reason than its quality.
Number 5's where we finished off from last time, so number 5 is Game of Thrones.
Like, I mean, Game of Thrones was wank.
It wasn't.
Like, I didn't like it. Like, it was too hammy for me. It was just a bit much. I didn't enjoy it. But, you know, props to everyone who did.
It was a good show, though. Yeah.
Well, it just wasn't for me. It just wasn't, like, wasn't my bag at all. But better than Fleabag.
Probably.
That was a lot of better than Fleabag.
Mate, it's outrageous. It's just, it's ridiculous.
Was there anything there that you would have put in?
Trying to think, man. Like, I can't think of particular.
There was two for me. Two for me.
Go on.
Norseman.
Oh, right.
Oh yeah.
Phenomenal. And Archer.
Archer's sick.
Archer's good. Sick. Yeah.
That was it.
Yeah.
Maybe I really like. There's a show on that. I don't think it might have got in the top 100. Did you ever see Lillehammer?
Yeah, it was all right, man. It was all right.
I really liked it.
Steve Van Zandt.
Yeah. Little Stevie or whatever he's called. Isn't that his name? I think from the E Street Band.
Yeah, he's in the E Street Band and Sopranos.
Sopranos is.
Yeah, what a career.
I can't believe Sopranos wasn't in there.
That's disgraceful, isn't it? Disgraceful.
Where would you put Archer? In that
100? Oh, no, I wouldn't be like, but it's better than some stuff in there.
It's better than some stuff in there, definitely.
Should be in the top 100. Yeah. Do you know what? I'm surprised Dexter's so low. Dexter was really good, man.
The end of this list is kind of mad, isn't it? Got Luther, Hannibal, Always Sunny, Dexter.
No, Ink Master. That's a notable exception.
I'm surprised there isn't one of them, though. Yeah. At least porn stars.
Yeah.
Oh, man, Bake Off. Food or something.
Bake Off's
iconic.
Oh yeah, yeah. No, that's
because if RuPaul's going in, which it should, like you can understand if they omit RuPaul, then you think, oh well, maybe it's just not those type of shows.
But like Bake Off's cultural impact is massive, isn't it?
Do you know what? I'm surprised it's not in there. Yeah. But I don't know whether it's only this century, but I think it is because I do think it's probably one of the best reality. I don't like it. It's not for me. Strictly.
Right. Yeah. Yeah, like I get it. It's super popular. My family all fucking love it.
It's super entertaining as well, yeah. Whether you like it or not. You've got the fucking idiots that can't dance and the ones that are, you're surprised that they can.
Yeah.
And I just
Hole in a Wall. That should have been in there. That should have been number one.
Ninia Benjamin did that.
Shit.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah, that was like, it was only like one series, wasn't
it? Yeah.
If you could go on any celebrity, what would you want to do? What's the reason that you want to get famous? When I was a kid, I just wanted to go on Soccer AM.
Yeah.
But now it's shit. But Soccer Aid is the dream.
That would be incredible. But like my dream when I was a little kid was to be on the cover of the NME. And now I couldn't give a fuck.
It's just
like an advert for Shockwave's hair gel now. But like when I was a kid, like the NME was like, I thought it was the coolest thing in the fucking world. I read it cover to cover every week.
Yeah.
Right. Its decline has been sad to say, but I think it mirrors
the decline of print media.
Yeah, but like they accelerated it worse. They could have like pivoted in different ways. They
especially because of the age of people who are reading it. They're all people who aren't internet adverse.
Yeah.
So I understand that fucking like History Weekly might struggle.
Exactly. But like, why couldn't the NME be like the biggest music website? You know, like it could have easily from the position it had. Anyway, but yeah, like I feel the same way about like panel shows though, you know, like when I got into comedy, I really wanted to be on panel
shows. That's interesting that like Mott the Week or something like that wasn't in there.
No, they are like, but they aren't because they're not that great, most of them, you know?
No, but like something like that. Well, like what's the best one of them, would you say? I think the one that people like the Mark's most
probably
is,
the
is
most
would popular. I lie to you.
Oh yeah, in terms of quality, I think that's probably the best one.
Or I'm surprised because of the wanks.
Just the Bob Mortimer episodes.
I'm surprised that the wanks that have compiled it haven't put QI in there though.
No, it's true.
Interesting.
But yeah, like it's a weird thing that I was just like, it was like my dream. I was like, oh, I'd love to be on them, and then I was just like, I just don't care.
What about now though?
Just don't care.
So you wouldn't want to? I'd love to be
they
on.
Offered, if they offered me, I'd go do it.
Oh, is there not one that you'd love to do?
Like, not, they're not like anywhere near any of like my big
like the best
dreams,
thing about being famous would that I'd get to go on Celebrity Pointless.
Oh, I'd love to do like that.
That's what I mean. Like, what's the one that you'd want to go on?
I'd do Pointless. I like Pointless. I think we'd be a good Pointless team, man. We could do it.
I'm busy.
Fuck, man. I've got loads of fucking knowledge. I'll be on another team. I'll see you on
Family Fortune. This is going to be like that Fresh Prince episode where they go on a TV show and start kicking off.
Yeah. I've not seen it.
You've not seen that one?
Fresh Prince wouldn't be on too late, innit? Too late for that.
Fresh Prince was on After School, wasn't it? On BBC Two.
Yeah, but it was like 90s though. I mean, like it wouldn't be on that list.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Tracy Beaker.
Yeah.
I'm surprised that. Is that 90s?
That's 90s.
I think so, yeah.
I don't know. I didn't watch it. Pointless would be sick.
Yeah, I love Pointless.
Like you see like comics on Mastermind, but comics that you're not like this isn't a disrespect, but like Rob Deering was on it and he's not like, you wouldn't know him in the street.
Yeah,
not like he's the celebrity, really, Rob.
Yeah, he's like a niche celebrity. He's on Six Music quite a lot.
Oh, is he?
He's often contributes to that and stuff.
I like Rob a lot.
Yeah, he's a fucking great guy.
Have you listened to his podcast with Tonks?
I haven't, but Mrs. does when she goes running.
Fucking mad how they do that. So have you heard? Yeah. So they do a podcast while running.
So they have like headset mics and they talk to each other while they're having a run.
I just imagine.
I can't listen to that.
Yeah, you would hear me die. That would be my Tommy Cooper moment.
We should do a special episode with us two unfit fuckers doing a run.
Let's do it. Because when you got out of my car before, you run well weird.
Yeah, I did a funny run around the car. Yeah, I did do a funny run. Like there was a bit of a funny run into it, but I do funny runs to compensate for the fact that I run weird.
Like me with my ironic dancing.
I can't dance. Yeah, man. I do. Like, I'm too limmy. I'm not very coordinated. I'm not a graceful man, am I?
Scottish.
But like, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not coordinated. I'm like a fucking, you know, like, I'm like a collection of sticks.
It was very Jack Skellington.
You know, those inflatable.
We don't have them, do we, though?
America,
it's mad how, like, that is a thing that everyone in this country knows about. I've never seen one in this country.
I built one for the end of one of my Edinburgh shows.
What?
I made a waving arm inflatable, man. Yeah, I bought a car fan and a car battery and hooked them up. and I built a switch into it on a dog cage, and then I put, like, built like with ripstop nylon, made the tube, and I had Jack Whitehall's face on it. It was for a point at the end of my show.
Was it a diss at Whitehall?
No, it wasn't. It was just it was about
because he'll get the Rock to batter you.
Yeah, I really like Jack. I've met him like twice, and he was lovely.
He's
like,
dead sound.
It wasn't a diss at him.
Friend of the show.
Yeah, but
doesn't know it exists.
It was a show about middle class comedians, and obviously he is like the icon of it, you know?
Yeah,
he's like the first one that springs to most people's mind, so that's
why you're not good at Pointless, mate.
Yeah,
that's such a family
because I wasn't trying to do a niche thing, was it? I was trying to get the point across. I was trying to do a Family Fortune.
Yeah, if you were playing Pointless, you'd have gone Glenn Moore, mate. Shout out Glenn Moore, who consistently has
Ken Cheng.
He's up there with the best Edinburgh titles.
Oh, mate, he always has the best.
He called one Edinburgh show the very best of Belinda Carlisle.
Yeah.
It's fucking brilliant. Yeah. Like, I still don't know why to this day, but...
Yeah.
Excellent. What was the other? Glenn Gary.
Yeah. More. How do you like it?
Oh, and Love Don't Live Here, Glenn Moore. Yeah. Very good. That's him and Lycett.
They're the head of the game, them two.
Yeah.
That talking while jogging, my friend does that. She always makes a point when she's, you know, jogging with people to always keep a conversation. And I asked her about it and she said, because if you can't talk, you're running too fast.
Yeah.
So like, yeah, that's why
I don't know about that. What if I want to run this fast? Running too fast for what? That's so like subjective.
If you're doing a jog, you've got, you know, like a route to complete.
Yeah, you've got to be pacing it. You don't want to be like going out of the traps too fast so you can't get around.
And then having to like walk with a stitch in
it. It depends what you, literally depends what you're trying to do.
Yeah, but if you're like running from the cops.
You're not really talking.
But it also depends on your heart rate, like where you're like, because there's a training zone, isn't there? So the only reason you can really tell that is with like a heart rate monitor. If you're running too fast or not.
I know, that's just a rule of thumb measuring it.
Tell her to shut the fuck up, especially while she's
Ring
running.
Ring Sid on this. Right.
Sid runs.
Yeah, well, you should know then.
I'm running down to the job centre after this. Stitched him right up. Hey, Stitch. Hey, get it.
Yeah, you did an A then.
Yeah, because I didn't mean it.
Sorry, I've got to judge the ones you mean.
Fleabag is number four.
Mate, it's outrageous.
Like, I've not even seen it, but it can't be better than some of them things. Like,
it's just not. It's just not.
Like, I wonder if there's been any like backlash.
What to the
from
list?
From that list?
Oh, there will be, like, anything like that.
Is it on Twitter, that list? Is it trending or anything?
Let's have a look.
They'll definitely, like, someone will be upset about it somewhere. Like, you know, some people might dedicate a whole fucking podcast to it.
Yeah, well, then they'd be the real kings.
Real G's.
That might just be enough to sneak us on a 98.
What, at this pod?
Yeah, just push fucking Attenborough out, or whatever 100 was, Hannibal. Push fucking Mads Mikkelsen out, or whatever it is.
Yeah, there's some backlash here. I found a tweet from... BBC News PR.
Yeah.
Let me just text the link to you, Danny.
Look at Mubs with his technology.
And I'm doing a text off his laptop.
I know.
Madness.
What year is this?
Futuristic, mate.
Yeah. Oh,
that come
I've got a text. I can't believe Love Island's not on there. They should do 100 shit.
The first one is like about The Sopranos and West Wing.
Oh, yeah. 98. Oh, I've lost it. Wait there. What? So this is people... Oh. I mean, John Sternfield here, he has got a bit of a point where he's put leaving out The Sopranos and The West Wing because they premiered in 99 seems nonsensical. They ran almost entirely in the 21st century.
But is that
yeah,
like
that does make sense.
With but it, using Powell?
No, because like most of the series was released in this century. They were of this century, you know, like... So I think if a single episode was aired this century, it should be in.
Yeah, maybe.
Because it is released in this century.
Yeah, but what if it was like the opposite, though? What if it was like fucking... If Only Fools and Horses have got an episode in this century.
Yeah, but you've got to judge it on that episode. You can't do it on the back catalogue before it.
So they can't... They
so
can't
season
the
one
pilot.
Of The Sopranos, you got to leave out.
Yeah, but then you were if you mean you leave it out or you would raise it from history?
You'd not raise it from history.
Because then the rest wouldn't make sense.
No, it wouldn't. There'd be a lot of stuff that like, I feel like this should have been foreshadowed somehow. But no, I think even without series one of The Sopranos, it still fucking shits on Fleabag, isn't it? You could watch a random episode of Sopranos with no context and you will get more out of it.
Yeah.
They know what they're doing with that as well, the image that they've used. So they've used Mad Men, Fleabag, and I May Destroy You in the... Is it I May or I Will?
I don't know.
I don't want to get that wrong. I have a lot of mubs. And
I think it's I May.
I May.
Yeah. I got it right. Oh, someone's met. There's a couple of glaring omissions, actually.
Oh, yeah.
So you could argue, as much as it's the fucking TV of Dars, Peaky Blinders should be in the top 100.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Definitely in terms of like cultural impact again.
And Ozark.
Oh, yeah.
No, Ozark.
Oh, yeah, Ozark.
That was dumb.
Yeah, silly.
Yeah, a lot of people are pissed about The Sopranos being omitted.
Yeah, I think that's just needlessly snide.
Yeah, I just think they didn't want that battle. Yeah, they didn't want that Wire chat. Well,
Sopranos is better than Wire. I don't think so
because I saw The Wire first, so I think The Wire's better. But I'm not arguing with anyone about that. Yeah. I will say I think that's better, and that will be the end of the chat. We are going to... No, I mean, like...
I know, it's just the way you said it. It was like, you know, that's the fucking end of it.
We are going to do a Patreon episode about The Wire, actually, about can The Wire save the world? And we might do a Sopranos one later on.
Yeah.
And we're going to do a Game of Thrones one, but a lot of them soon come. When Molly's back as well, because Molly's ill. Shout out. By the way, right, big shout out coming up.
It's all good. Appreciate y'all, though.
We'll make it clap. We'll make it clap.
It's all good. Appreciate y'all, though.
Hold on. We may as well get this right.
This is why like people don't DJ with their feet.
I know. Oh, before we crack on, a big...
We'll make it clap.
Let's do a look.
We'll make it clap.
Still fucked up.
That doesn't matter. The thoughts there. Big shout out to the DDP's own Molly McGuinness for
fucking smashing
for getting
it
to the final of the BBC New Comedy Awards.
Yeah, man, just coming on BBC One.
Was it BBC Unos?
It's getting on Unos, mate.
It's right.
It's shown on Unos.
Best give her a t-shirt to wear.
Yeah, yeah. Let's cover her in fucking stickers and send her down to the final. She got any material about tote bags?
Like the boy with tape on his face, the girl with stickers all over her person. The girl with stickers on her body, just all over her head.
Part of her body.
Yeah, you part fucking of her body. Prick.
Yes.
Oh, do you know what? I wonder if, let's give Molly a bell. See what Molly's up to. It's like we're checking up on her, seeing if she's really ill.
I know, like, she's going to put on a sick voice.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you know when... Oh.
It's not that kind of ill, but like...
Do you know when work phone you?
Yeah.
You watch now, they'll be like, in the background, they'll be like, it's like a house party, noise and that.
She going to ghost us?
Oh, she must be in bed, so ill. She's pied us right off.
I mean, she is actually legit.
No, she is genuinely ill. So not only get well soon, but congratulations to Molly there. Have you ever done any, apart from that false start, comedy competitions?
Yeah, I did. I did all the competitions when I started. I did the BBC one when it was only on radio.
Where'd you get to? What'd you get up to?
Got to semis, I think.
Who was in it? Anyone who's big ting now?
Well, Mickey P. Kerr beat me in my semi.
Oh.
Because, you know, got a guitar, it's cheating.
It's horrible, that. I don't know why my WhatsApp does that on here.
Fucking horrific.
Is your silent switch on?
Oh, yeah, it's on now, but I just don't know why it's that tone.
It's grim. Okay. Who else was in that? I don't know. Joe Lycett hosted it.
Right.
But I can't remember who... Was it... I think... Did Yuriko Kitani win?
What year was it?
Again, yeah, don't remember. I do not remember. Mate, I'm awful. I don't remember years and shit. Like, I don't remember.
But you know that the head is a part of the body.
But I know the head's part of the body, mate. I know proper knowledge. But yeah, I did all the comedy competitions for a while, and I was glad to stop them. Like, I came third in the Leicester Mercury. That was the most prestigious one I did.
Oh, mate, I've got big beef with that.
Oh, yeah.
I've got massive, massive beef.
Yeah.
So, when I got nominated for that. To do it.
Yeah, so you get nominated for the final in the Leicester Mercury.
Yeah.
Like, promoters around the country, like, they get to pick from their region someone.
And I got nominated for it, and they wouldn't let me do it because I'd done certain weekend clubs, and apparently you had to be new.
Yeah.
But there was loads of acts on there that did weekend. They just didn't want me to do it.
Yeah.
Fucking grim.
Yeah. The year I did it, it was just like a
And I would have had a chance that year, I think, because, like, at the time... I was a little bit further on and maybe a little bit more experienced than the guy that won it, who is now a big deal.
Yeah, yeah.
And that could have been me, man.
It's not though, is it?
No,
stuck here on a fucking sofa with me.
I know. Gutted, just staring at Mubs and wondering why he's got a coat on. Yeah, I'll do this and you can tell me if I'm funnier than this guy and be honest.
Okay.
And I think you'll say that I am, but, okay. And I think...
Better than Fleabag.
Yeah, is he better than Fleabag?
Yeah, worse than Fleabag. No, I prefer you.
I'm well funnier than him.
I prefer you.
He's a lovely guy.
He is. He's very nice, actually. But
I'm funnier than him.
I prefer you, yeah.
Yeah.
But I think most people prefer him.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, he's way more like, you know, he's more mainstream appeal.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'll send you a picture, Mubs.
But yeah, I don't think I paid off anyone like really good, like, you know, who blew up to be like huge. I mean, like, there's always a great comedian that they did like competitions with, but I mean, like, people who went like massive. Like, Sam Gore's the funniest one of them. He beat like people, like everyone.
Yeah, it's
everyone
weird,
in his like final that he won this competition was like, Joe Lycett was one of them. I think Kath Ryan was in it. I think
really?
It was like, mate, it was like absurd.
Slaying him with
it
his
It was
five.
Just all, yeah, just all of like these, like the whole like final he was in at this competition was like, everyone is now like doing stadiums and shit.
Mad. Yeah. Oh, I'm going to ring Rachel.
Gore's the best though. He's fucking brilliant. But he's also just, you know, he just didn't try for ages.
Yeah, I've seen that picture, man. You're well better.
Yeah, I think so.
Who are we trying now?
Hello.
Hi, Rachel.
Hi, Rachel.
Danny McLaughlin from the Damn Daniel podcast. I'm here with Rob and Mubs. Molly's ill.
Oh, hello, everybody.
Hiya, mate.
Have you seen Fleabag?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Yes.
Don't even want to talk about it.
We're basically, the whole podcast today is us looking. Have you seen that list of the 100 greatest TV shows in this century?
Yeah, compiled by people that were born yesterday.
Yes! Yes!
Basically, I'd
agree. Yeah,
I hate when people talk about the set, but you've caught me at a good point, actually. I'm just in the boozer.
Oh, nice. Where?
Yeah, I'm in London.
Oh, that London.
In the pub. Yeah, I'm in the pub. I've had a couple of pints. Yeah, so I have a thing in my set where I talk about Fleabag and I say... people don't like it when I say the word cunt, but when Fleabag says it, it's groundbreaking.
Yes!
It is. It really annoys me. It's like, it's all right for middle-class women to talk about being done up the bum in episode one.
Exactly.
But if a working-class woman
yes.
talks about, oh, I had anal sex last night, it's like, oh, she's so crass.
Yeah. Preach, mate. Preach. This was I made a very similar point earlier. I highly agree with you.
Can I also? Can I send you a picture and you tell me if I'm better than this comedian?
Yeah, you're sending it now.
Yeah.
Also, Rachel, do you think that the head is part of the body?
Yeah. Hold on.
The head.
Yeah, your head.
It's the main part of the body.
There you go.
The
heaviest part of the body. Thank you, Rachel.
Fuck off.
Thank you.
Fuck off.
It's the heaviest part of the body.
Exactly.
It's
part of the
body. Most of your body.
Exactly.
It's not most of your body.
What about your chest? Like your torso?
There are conditions where you end up with it being most of your body.
It's not most of
your brain's the heaviest. I don't know, is it?
It's not the most of your body, though, is it?
It's not my fucking heaviest organ, I'll tell you that. Hey?
It's the one in the chair.
I'm quite ill.
Did you get that text?
Oh, hang on, let me have a look. Let me just check. Hang on.
Don't say his name.
Undoubtedly.
Yes.
Yes.
He won Leicester Mercury the year I wasn't allowed to do it because I'd done a weekend at the Frog and I think I might have had a chance is the point.
Well, you know, these things don't matter, but sometimes, you know, people's careers are their careers.
No. It's not a slight on his career at all. I'm just saying at that point, I even made a point to say I was a bit further on than him. And at that point in time...
Yeah, but even still now,
I know.
In my opinion, because it's subjective, you are still funnier.
Yeah, I know that. But
all right, well, you've got me 2 pints in now, so I'm on one.
I know, this is great. We've got a right at the perfect point here. Let's start naming some fucking names.
What pub are you in?
I'm in the George in London. Where? In Borough Market.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
The oldest pub in London, 1676.
Is it the oldest pub in London?
Apparently so, yeah.
Is it the first one they built after the fire?
It's a National Trust property.
It must have been.
No, it might have been. I mean, I don't know that much.
About the right time, innit?
Well, no, because fire didn't burn the whole thing down, so it was probably, yeah. When they say London, London then was like very, it was the city of London, innit, which is very a small area. Yeah. It's not like
listen, I've had a lovely day.
Oh, tell us about it.
I went to Holloway Prison.
I thought you were going to say Holland and Barrett then. I've had a lovely day. I've got some St. John's wort.
No, I went to Holloway Prison it's a location now for films and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
So I went there.
What film?
We're thinking, they're filming Gangs of London or something at the minute.
And
boyfriend, he works in production and all that kind of stuff.
All right.
Well, I'm actually sitting with Ricky from the Kaiser Chiefs having a pint as well. We're having
Shout
a
out, Leeds legend.
Put him on.
No, absolutely not.
Let me ask him if the head is part of the body.
I know Simon. I know one of the other Kaisers.
He's had a few drinks.
Can you at least ask him if Curb Your Enthusiasm is better than Fleabag?
Ask him if he thinks the head is part of the body.
Yeah.
No, I can't.
Go on, just ask him that.
No. Do you want me or him? You got me. Let me speak. Anyway, so went to Holloway Prison, and because we might be using it for a photo shoot for something.
Oh, yeah.
The podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, it was dead creeper.
Yeah, it's a prison. It's not meant to.
It's not
soft play.
No, but it's all a
Holloway Prison stroke jungle bungle.
Now and scary. It was honestly right. So what happened was when I went in, I got this horrible feeling. I thought, oh, I'm going to chuck up, mate.
I thought I'm going to be sick.
I thought I had a really horrible feeling.
Holloway Prison. Let's have a look at the inmates list.
Oh yeah, let's find some.
Myra Hindley.
Fucking
Carr.
Oh, shit.
This is better than when we did Famous People from Leeds, isn't it?
Yeah, it's well better than Famous People from Leeds. The Suffragettes.
Oh, yeah.
The Suffragettes. Well, yeah, they were in the older prison, yeah.
Emmeline Pankhurst, Emily Day, all the big
women.
Irish Republic.
Yeah, it was a women's prison, yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
I think sounds really nice. I reckon it would have been. I think Rose West in there for a bit. I think a women's prison. You know, all right, they've committed awful crimes, but I bet there'd be like a knitting circle,
mate. Have you
classes,
fucking someone's talking like they've never seen Bad Girls.
You know what? I auditioned for that years and years ago when I was 17.
Were you not a bad enough girl?
No. Shit.
I didn't get the part. They wanted me to do a Cockney accent and I couldn't do it.
Oh, that's a thingy now, isn't it? That's a thingy now. A hotel, I think. The prison the prison that they use for bad girls is now a Hilton or something.
Mate,
is it really?
Yeah, prison themed bar in Manchester now.
Called Alcotraz.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
You get dressed up in jumpsuits and like, it's all like, yeah, it's like you go into a cell and have like prison themed cocktails. I don't know, I think they're called like, you know, shanked in the shower.
Yeah. Fucking.
Not sex on the beach, it's sex on the fucking tiles.
On the rock. That's what it should be called.
I don't know if this should go on the podcast, but I did find it really funny. So when you've got to go to the old Holloway prison, you go past, what is it, the men's prison that's still open? And it's on Holloway, I can't remember.
Pentonville.
Anyway, they had a pride flag flying over the top. I thought, well, if anywhere's going to be up for it, it's going to be in there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Good luck to you, lads.
Your dad calls it Bentonville.
The prison service has always been very LGBT friendly, hasn't it?
Notable inmates from Pentonville include
Pete Doherty.
He
wrote a song about it. And he ended up
Boy George had been in there.
Maybe that's why the flag was there.
Yeah.
Boy George, he tied that Rent Boy to the radiator.
Oh, yeah.
And George Michael for drink driving.
Yeah, when he went into the snappy snaps.
So I can totally understand why this flag is flying. Did you just say that someone tied a rent board to the radiator?
Yeah, Boy George. Handcuffed.
He did a Terry Waits on a game.
Terry Waits there.
Yeah.
he handcuffed a male prostitute. You're probably not allowed to say rent boy anymore.
No, I think you're right. Yeah.
You can't even bloody say rent boy anymore.
What's this world coming to? When you can't even say child whore.
Oh God, this is, do you know what, don't ring me again when I'm at
just ask him,
I better get back
if the head is part of the body.
Yeah, just ask him.
You don't have to bring him on.
Alright, so I ask him.
Yeah,
I'll ask Tim. Tim, the boyfriend,
and ask Tim as well. Can will Tim come on?
I'm not putting you on speaker, there's too many people.
No, can you give Tim just the phone?
Danny's podcast.
Oh yeah,
is the head a part of the body?
Yes,
thank you.
What do you mean, is the head the part of the body? Yeah.
Is that Tim? Is that Tim?
Is the head the part of the body?
Yeah.
Can I?
Yeah,
ask,
there you go.
Is that Tim? Can you tell them my logic? My logic was
there's no logic.
No, wait, Rob. You know, in like boxing, when they say like they do headshots and body shots, they count them different.
Oh, the head is the heaviest part of the body. I don't know what your logic is here.
Would you say your brain's in your body?
Would you say the brain's in the body?
Pickle. Yes, of course it is.
Would you say?
Yeah.
Because this all come from where Rob went, oh, I was so wrecked, my brain wasn't even in my body.
Yeah.
And I don't think the brain is in the body.
That's a hypothetical thing you're saying.
Oh, exactly. Thank you.
Pathetic.
Thank you for speaking sense.
Spiritual. That's a spiritual thing you're saying. It's just,
it wasn't literal.
When you feel rubbish and you're hungover or whatever, you're like, oh, my head's not my own.
Yes, thank you.
You've been to one prison.
Well, as far as you know.
Oh, yeah, I suppose.
Yeah.
Have you been to more prisons?
Don't you ask me that. I'm not going to talk about it. I need to go now.
Oh, do you know what I heard a story about when I went to see my granddad in prison and I didn't know he was in prison and my family told me he was working away?
Oh, no.
And I was working away sewing mailbags.
Yeah, he was working away and his uniform was the same as everyone else that worked there. And I still don't know.
When did you get off?
I don't know the details to this day, but it was open prison. And I went to see him and I didn't know. It was like working away. So I'll leave you with that little story there. Say hello to
Tim.
Made
it, didn't I? I will.
And,
thank you for having me.
No, thanks for coming on and hopefully see you soon.
Yeah, catch you soon.
All
mate.
Right, speak to you later.
Cheers, mate. Bye. Bye, 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 bye.
How does it feel knowing that Ricky Wilson from the Kaiser Chiefs thinks you're a fucking idiot?
Well, I don't care because...
I think he's an idiot.
Yeah.
Are you cussing him out?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's wrong.
Well, he's not. Everyone we've spoken to has agreed with me.
Mate, Ricky Wilson is below Harry Ramsden in the famous people from Leeds. So, or wherever he was below.
Yeah, the UK Colonel, put some respect on Harry Ramsden's name.
The Lieutenant.
Yeah. Well, it'd be the Lieutenant, wouldn't he, in Britain?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's weird, that.
Yeah, it is.
It is weird, that.
It is weird. Just spell it different.
Yeah, but if you're going to do that, you have to bring the same energy for colonel or whatever it's called. Colonel.
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 Yeah. But everyone has agreed with me.
Yeah, so, but it's because when Danny asks the question, he's always done it first, like, is the head a part of the body?
Instead of saying...
Danny has been able to ask the question however he wanted. I have not interfered. If he's fucked it up, that's all.
I have interfered a bit.
I've just sat there and let him ask the question.
Well, you haven't.
Once the question was asked, I might have chipped in a little, but once
shit, then you fucking baked potato.
Once they'd already gone, what the fuck are you on about, you idiot? Of course it fucking is.
I can't believe Ricky Wilson from the guy. The disdain in his voice.
Just like, I know, I just heard about it.
Like, it was like someone had just told him that they were worse than the pigeon detectives. It was like someone told him the pigeon detectives were the biggest band from Leeds. Oh, fuck. I preferred the Sunshine Underground Wilson.
Fucking Milburn Ultra over here.
Where were Milburn
fucking
from?
Bromhead's jacket. They're Sheffield, them two.
I saw them in Wrexham.
I've seen them loads of times.
Nine people in there. Yeah. Woohoo! What if maybe? Yeah. We've played them on here because they've got the worst song ever.
Yeah.
The song about the tube.
Yeah, it's bad.
Oh, it's so bad.
Bless them.
Anyway. Wonder what they do now. I wonder where you are now.
I mean, I don't think they make a living out of being a band.
No, I think you're right. I don't think a lot of...
probably in the cloakroom taking Bromhead's jackets.
Probably a spud. You like making Bromhead's jackets.
Mate, they work in a sugar factory making Bromhead's packets. Mate, I've seen them down at the tennis centre, yeah, with their Bromhead's rackets.
They're at Millwall or wherever he manages now, taking Kenny Jackets, Bromhead's jacket.
But, you know, best of luck to him.
Yeah, man. Best of luck to him, indeed. They had some good songs, though.
They were fun, man. Back then, like, there was a lot of, like, them, like, you know, around the time, it was a good laugh.
Their demos were better. They were overproduced. That was their issue.
Happened to a lot of those indie bands around then, because Arctic Monkeys got so big, suddenly loads of money flooded in.
And they all got
signed up by big labels and polished up, and it didn't work for half of them.
Because
there was a thing where suddenly Yorkshire was the cool place to be from because of Arctic Monkeys.
Mm.
So then every fucking Yorkshireman with a guitar got a record deal. Mm. Basically for a while.
Apparently they go around fields now looking for moles, trying to Bromhead's whack it.
No, it's quite sad actually. Yeah, one of them's got addicted to Bromhead's smack it.
Oh, and do you know what? He was that smacked up, he tried to go on his skateboard and I saw him Bromhead stack it.
They gotta be careful when they're hitting the moles, they don't hit a Bromhead's rabbit.
Doesn't work.
Doesn't work.
Doesn't work.
Doesn't work.
Doesn't work.
No.
If you listen more, you might.
No.
If you listen more, you might be able to eventually Bromhead's crack it. And then we'll be able to Bromhead's back it.
Yeah. I don't know if mostly can Bromhead's hack it.
No. Oh, that's what it is. You didn't quite nail it. You didn't even Bromhead's tack it. That's enough now.
That's done. Right, we'll move on.
Should we have a little break?
Yeah, let's have a little. Let's I can little do little with break. A wee wee.
Oh, we're back. We've had a break.
Yeah,
we nearly did our first episode of the feature that we're going to do. That is almost definitely Haram.
Yeah.
Called Mubs in Pubs. And I was going to take Mubs the Brew.
But Danny got scared, man.
I got shook because I'm scared of the brew because I've heard about, like, well, I'm aware of things that have gone on in there.
Yeah. I was well up for it. I was excited.
I know. You got a little, I've got a little bit of snoot douche. On your snoot.
I've got it.
Gone now, Rob. Good. I had a hazelnut whisper. God, do you have one as well?
I didn't have one in the end. No, I thought it was a bit too much sugar for this time of the afternoon.
Oh, it's the perfect time in the afternoon just when you need a little pick-up.
Yeah, well, to be fair, I did get a can of Coke.
Yeah, exactly. This is the time of the afternoon where Winnie the Pooh would have a little bit of condensed milk. A little spoonful of condensed milk. Yeah. He'd have a little something round about now.
It's a proper nana snack, that, isn't it? Just having a bit of condensed milk.
Yeah, I'm not aware of it. Like, is condensed milk's evaporated milk, right?
That's, I think it's carnation thing. I think that's how you.
That you have on tinned peaches.
Yeah, that's how. Yeah. I thought you have it with desserts. I didn't realize.
Yeah. Itself. Yeah. He has it with a little spoonful of honey on
a
bit of bread.
Milk on bread.
Condensed milk on bread. That's what Rabbit offered him, and he said, I don't want the bread.
Yeah.
Just gives the fucking condensed moo moo and the honey.
Don't need a milky bread.
He's a good bear.
He's a pretty good bear, yeah.
He's such a good dude, Winnie the Pooh. He's a bear of very little brain.
Yeah.
But he's up there with my favourite bears.
Yeah. Who's number one?
Jonathan Mayer. No. I don't even
bear
know.
If Grylls.
He's a bear. Yeah, he's a good bear. It might be Pooh, you know. Do you know who can fuck off? Yeah. That Tory cunt Rupert.
Yeah, Rupert can fuck off. He is dead Tory.
He's like, the worst bear.
I used to like him when I was
He's
a
fucking Jacob Rees-Mogg bear, isn't he?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely. Probably his kids are called like Wolfhound and stuff. He's got mad Anglo-Saxon names for his kid, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Like Wolfstan or something.
Oh, Jacob Rees-Mogg. Yeah, well, he's like a fucking, like, you know, he's living in the Victorian times, isn't he?
He goes and hides out on Athelney Marshes and burns the cakes. Fucking bell.
He is a fucking bell.
Yeah. I hope the Vikings get him. The fucking...
Vikings?
Yeah, because that's who the adversary of the Anglo-Saxon Brit wasn't
right,
it?
You're going way back on that one.
Well, yeah, because that's what he's naming his kids after, like, people from that
Ethelred.
Time. You've got... List of Rees-Mogg's kids' names. I bet there's not a Mason amongst. There's not a Jack amongst. Yeah,
none of these are going to be called Winston, are they?
Fuck me, this first one, mate. Sixtus Dominic Boniface Christopher Reeves Mogg.
Fucking hell.
What? Sixtus.
Christopher Reeves Mogg as well.
Yeah.
Like,
I know, yeah.
Sounds like you've got two popes and a Superman. What the fuck?
The girl one's the most normal one. So he's got six kids, right? So the girl's called Mary Ann Charlotte Emma Reeves Mogg.
So yeah. Mary Ann and Charlotte are the Bronte sisters.
Yeah.
Yeah. And who's the fourth one?
Emma.
Yeah.
That's right. The name of a novel, isn't it?
So is it Mary Ann?
Charlotte.
Yeah, Emma. Sorry. So Charlotte, Emma and Anne, or well, it's Emily Bronte, are the Bronte sisters.
Charlotte, Emma, Anne. All right. Yeah, okay. So yeah, just the first one, then Mary.
I think they're just quite traditional English names, I think. That.
Yeah, but to have them all.
But
Emma
one.
And Emily aren't the same name.
No, I know, but I think that's what he's getting at, I bet you. It wouldn't surprise me. He's called his kid after fucking two popes and a Superman. Do you know what I mean?
One's called Anselm Charles Fitzwilliam.
Anselm's a very Anselm. Old English name. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's a Saint Anselm. Have a look if there's a Saint Anselm. There might
isn't
even
that
be...
where Molly used to work? Anselmus.
that's the Asian Anselm, is that?
Anselm of Canterbury.
Yeah. Is he a saint? I'm sure there's a Saint Anselm. There might even be like a Saint Anselm's College in Oxbridge. Yeah.
Oh, no. Saint Anselm of Canterbury was the outstanding Christian philosopher.
I know too much things, me.
Yeah.
Just watched a lot of Tony Robinson documentaries, haven't
walking
you?
Walking through Britain.
Yeah, you've walked
walking
all the way through,
history,
through it.
Sorry. Yeah. Who's his others?
Oh, fucking hell. Alfred Wolfric.
There
Mason,
you go.
Pius.
Wolfric.
Reesmog.
Alfred. King Alfred.
Yeah.
Alfred the Great.
Peter Theodore Alfieg.
Was he naming them after the fucking chipmunks?
Yeah, chipmunks, yeah.
And then the last one is Thomas Wentworth Somerset Dunstan Rees-Mogg.
Fucking hell.
So Dunstan is an...
Thomas, you're like, all right. And then you're like, Wentworth, dumbest... It sounds like fucking a place where you go buy pillows.
Why do they need five names, though?
So Dunstan is like an old priest.
Oh, yeah.
And he sat through... He was like Archbishop of Canterbury, maybe, through like eight different kings or something like that.
Was this when the kings were like turning over pretty quick?
There was just
when
like
there was
a
like
succession.
Lady Jane Grey.
No, well earlier than that.
Right.
So when was Dunstan about? So Dunstan apparently had the vision for a cathedral. I think it might have been Canterbury Cathedral.
He had the vision for it. Didn't do anything, just
had
the idea.
No, I think he was like the guy that... Can you have a look?
Yeah, so he was from the year 909. Bro, he lived a long life, you know.
Yeah, 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 that's what I mean. He's like...
He died like 79 or something.
1979.
See a picture of him in flares.
988 is when he died. 988. How would you say that year?
988.
Yeah.
988.
Yeah, 988. That's when he died. So yeah.
So like, yeah, lived into his 80s, which for that era
is madness.
Yeah.
Probably had no teeth problems.
Oh, definitely. Well, definitely had no teeth. It'll have had wooden teeth back then, innit?
So he had this thing where they apparently he flew. That's why he did so well. Apparently it's like propaganda. Right. So he like fell off somewhere. I've read a book and
he's like, oh, I flew actually then.
No, well, sort of. So the way that they dramatize it in this book is like he fell, but his like foot caught this rope and it like he fell down and he didn't die because the rope caught him.
So yeah. At the second of them, the floor of the hall where the Witten was standing, it was sitting, gave way and all except Dunstan, who clung to a beam, fell into the room below. And several men were killed.
So they thought it was like, that was his miracle and stuff.
Held on to a beam.
Does it say how many kings that, so what was he? Was he the Archbishop of Canterbury at one point or something?
Yeah.
Right.
An abbot of Glastonbury Abbey, Bishop of Worcester, Bishop of
Worcester.
London.
Worcester.
Got Molly's disease now.
What, kidney failure? I hope she's all right.
Yeah, fingers crossed. Shout out to Mel.
It's not kidney failure, by the way. It's just got an infection.
I'm on the Wikipedia, innit? I can't find anything clear about how many kings he's been through.
I've been through so many
sounds
kings.
Sounds like Grace Kelly.
Yeah, God knows.
Well, shout out to Dunstan.
Shout out Dunstan, mate. Yeah.
We'll make it clap.
Shout I'm just impressed and live so
we'll make it clap.
Yeah, it's mad.
1,000 years ago.
Do you reckon they did those interviews they always do with the world's oldest man where they're like, what's your secret? And he's like, I smoked 40 fags a day.
It's always 40 fags a day,
40 fags a day and a bottle of whiskey, always, yeah.
I think the secret is to live long is to be a Japanese woman.
Yeah, I think there's a lot of them. There's a lot of them crushing it.
That's the main secret, I think.
Yeah, they are killing it.
But I wonder, and this isn't meant to be funny, I wonder if the pollution and the mercury in the water will be an issue and that will be reflected in...
Maybe.
Because that...
Mercury's more... Well, I guess it is a problem if you eat a lot of fish.
Well, that's what I'm talking about.
They eat
a lot of fish
in Japanese diet, though. That's one of the reasons it's healthy.
That's what I'm saying, yeah. So I wonder if that's going to have an effect.
I'm sure it would.
Someone's going to take over the crown. I wonder if it's going to be the Mexican woman.
Maybe like
something.
The Greeks or something. They, like, you know, Mediterranean diet.
They eat Olivia oil spread. Yeah, remember that was, yeah. I remember that when I was a kid. It was like, oh, the Greeks live so long because they eat Olivia oil spread. It's just like, nah.
Nah, it's not the butter. It's not just that they're pieing butter constantly. Yeah. It's that they eat salads and that.
Do you know who live dead long?
Oh, yeah.
Italian.
Yeah. Yeah, so it's like Mediterranean, all around the Mediterranean. Mm. It's that diet of like a lot of olive oil and like
I bet you if you
stuff.
Look at those Dolmio puppets in 200 years' time, they'll look exactly the same.
They creep me out, man. You know, it's the combination of puppets and real food that I don't like.
Oh, that's interesting. Like, you think they should have used like shoelaces and
stuff? Yeah, I think they should have spaghetti. Because like they put it
that's
into
That's really funny.
They put it into their mouth and then it just grosses me out because someone's going to have to like clean out that felt mouth from all the fucking Dolmio that they put into it. They should have fake puppet food.
So while he's cleaning out the felt mouth, he would have felt mouth.
Yeah, man. It's like a gigs bar, isn't it?
Felt mouth is such a weird, like, it's. I think I quite like it for kissing.
What, you think like you'd like to kiss
like
a felt mouth?
No, like an... Would you fuck like a Dolmio an analogy? Puppet? Is it an analogy? Like a euphemism?
Oh, yeah. Right. I felt mouth.
Yeah, I felt mouth last night. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. Cool. Yeah. I like put lips on as well.
Yeah, lips in's good, yeah.
She put lips on you, yeah, mate.
Yeah. We just went with pulling.
Do you know what the worst one is? Copping off. Yeah. Copping off and tapping off. I remember that was like that was one of the original your dar shouts on this podcast was your dar asked if you copped off with some totty. That's such a your dar thing. Yeah. Top totty. Yeah.
Totty is
that. Oh, it's horrible. It's so, you know what it is?
A lovely bit of crumpet.
It's not even that. Like, it's beyond that. Crumpet's very Radio 2.
Yeah.
Totty is very like FHM era. Like, it's not even Nuts Romping. Magazine. It's like it's like FHM and Loaded. It's that 1995 era. Like Britpop.
Yeah, like outside, you never hear the word romp outside of a tabloid.
No, yeah.
It's only ever used.
And it's the middle name of Jacob Rees-Mogg's fourth kid.
That's Rhombus.
Christopher Reeves-Mogg. Christopher Reeves, Henry Cavill, fucking, what's the other cunt? Oh, what's he called?
Oh, Dean Cain.
Dean Cain.
Yeah.
Oh. That was when Terry Hatcher was FHM's 100th top.
She was prime totty, mate.
Yeah, she was top totty.
She was top totty.
So basically what we need to do now is go through FHM's top 100 list and we need to find out if it's better than Fleabag.
That'd be a cracking new misogynistic direction for this pod. I'm down for it.
This is the only thing I'm going to say on the matter, but... I slept with someone who ended up on the FHM 100 top.
Yeah, mate.
Yeah.
Genuine proudest moment of my life, I think, was a girl I slept with was in a Guardian article about how hard it is to be super attractive.
The troubles
that they face. The headline was, "Don't hate us because we're beautiful." And I was like, that ended up pinned to a corkboard at my
uniqueness. Yeah, but you're like, you know, like when really like privileged people do smack.
I was at rock bottom. Like, I'm fine. I'm well aware of that. I don't think I was a proud moment in her history. But
you were the equivalent.
I don't think I'm pinned to her corkboard.
Yeah. Yeah. You were the equivalent of the rich model kid doing smack through her toes.
Mate, that has basically been my entire dating history, going out with like ludicrously posh women who want to slum it but don't really want to.
Yeah.
Because like I'm the perfect like bit of rough for them because like I've got a northern accent, but I'm not gonna hit you and I've read some books.
Yeah.
You know, so I'm in
the
that,
Beano
like,
and the fucking dandy.
Yeah. But like I'm like, your dad'll be annoyed, but like you're not getting excommunicated.
Yeah, your dad'll be annoyed, but you'll still be in the will.
Exactly. Exactly. I'm that level. So like that's been my exact pitch, basically.
I mean, if it works.
Mate, I've found a method. I've stuck with it.
Fucking hell. Is that, yeah. This is my blueprint.
Yeah, man.
The blueprint too, baby. I'll behave. That was weird when Jay-Z used...
Austin Powers.
But he did his own voice in Austin Powers. Have you heard it?
Yeah.
So weird.
Yeah.
I'll behave. But Jay-Z, like the coolest man in the world.
Expect that from Kanye, innit? Not from
Jay-Z. Yeah, exactly. Not from Jigger.
Yeah.
Oh, I miss Jigger, man.
Like a dead good track on the new Kanye album. I really liked it. Like I did an audible gasp when I heard Jay on it. It was so good. Like the first time I
heard any Kanye West ever again.
Yeah, well, I liked it.
Poop Diddy Scoop was the best thing he's done in the last 5 years.
Do you know
years.
Why he did that? It's because he was beefing with Drake at the time, innit? And Drake wanted that beat.
Yeah.
I think he sent him that beat, but then he used that and started going poop scoop all over.
Yeah. Oh, right.
Fuck you, man. It was great.
I didn't know that.
Yeah,
that oh, that's fucking great.
Yeah. So that is like, funny,
Drake can't
it?
Use it now, innit?
What's the beat? Is that on?
Is it? It's not Lift Yourself, is it?
Is it? I want to hear the beat now. Just imagine Drizzy on it.
Yeah, Lift Yourself is what it's called. These bars? The hang-ups we have
today. Eating lobster. Eating lobster in a restaurant with Mara. Did you hear that one where Drake, he says that he's having food with Balotelli? Drake's got some bad bars, man.
Yeah.
This is for the guy that said on the Patreon, I think it was Harry, saying that there wasn't enough hip-hop.
Or he said, hip-hop.
I miss the hip-hop. So this is for you. We're going to have a little chat. I don't think you were here when we chatted about Drake, or was we?
I was here when we talked about Drake being a potential nonce.
Oh, no, it wasn't that, allegedly.
Allegedly.
I want to hear this beat now. It's a great beat.
Kanye tosses away amazing beats all the time with shit lyrics over them.
Yeah, but they're normally his beats.
Yeah.
So is this his beat? Oh, and Drake wanted it to buy off him.
I think he already gave it Drake.
Oh, so he did this so he couldn't spit anything on
yeah,
it.
Yeah. The hang-ups
we have today. And he's let the beat ride for ages, hasn't he? So he's let people hear how good the beat is.
Yeah.
And then he's threw some bullshit over it. Oh.
The way that stomps in.
It's a great beat. Rihanna would be good on this beat. It's a good Rihanna beat for
her.
I love Rihanna on so much.
The N.E.R.D. album. Lemon.
Oh, Lemon. Is that bad?
What?
Is that a bad song? I can't remember.
Lemon. Nah, it's good, but it's like, she didn't write that, innit? That's Pharrell. Three.
But first it'll piss you off. Hey, damn bitches wanna be my babe. Hey, coming down like the CIA. Hey, side of my car trying to see my face.
Right now. I get it how I live it.
Wait a minute.
I live it how I get it.
Wait,
come to motherfucking digits. I pull it with a lemon.
Wait a minute.
Not cause she ain't living.
Oh, I love
it's
her.
Just your eyes get acidic. And this ain't a scrimmage.
Wait a minute.
Motherfucker, we ain't finished.
Wait,
I told you
minute.
We won't stop. A nigga by the business.
Wait a minute.
Like yours, but you rent it.
What?
Wave hello to the top. Nigga, the bay wrong guy.
Wait a minute.
Tell the paparazzi get the lens right.
Wait a minute.
Got the window down.
Obviously on about the Bugatti Veyron shoes.
Yeah, loving them boots.
They were so bad. Do you remember when I messaged you because I'd forgotten about Angel Hayes? Who, like, I can't believe wasn't massive because I think she's, like, really good. Have you heard Angel Hayes?
I don't know if I have.
Mate, check
you
this.
You sent me something, didn't you?
Yeah, I think she's really good. So, any song we're clapping on, I'm into. Okay.
I'm running through the jungle, running like a slave through the underground tunnel. Told y'all niggas better get these bitches, cause I spit till my lips need 16 stitches. I am lyrical intrusion. You bitches can't see me like I'm really an illusion. I hop up on your face and do my motherfucking tooth death till I knock the meat out like a motherfucking toothpick. I'm nasty.
So good. Oh, this is a tune.
Okay, I'm Rambo, I ramshack. I'm next to that cheese like rat traps. On top of that green like grass ass. That's over y'all head like snapbacks. I get in where I fit in. Put up, then I put in. Tryna find an ass, I can put my fucking foot in. Run this shit, no, run this shit. Don't give one fuck, bitch, I run this shit. I did what I say I did. Did not fabricate one bit. I have been a fucking
too much hip hop.
Yeah, that's when I was born. Fuck what you want. All about me, bitch, fuck what you doing. Round of applause, bitch, I slap you with some clap, bitch, on my whole fucking ass like a fat bitch and chappers. I'll be running this shit like a motherfucking tracker, like I run on sins, like a motherfucking chapel, like a cheetah in a jungle, but I'm motherfucking fast like a preteen boy in a church with a pastor. Holla, I'm not serious, I'm just playing. Psych, fuck your opinion, bitch, I mean it when I'm saying that. Money and my money is the only shit I'm after. You can cut the fake shit, I'm not a motherfucking actor. I'm on top of my green like a motherfucking tractor. You niggas bout to be bitches, you bitches bout to be cast.
She's gonna make bitches Casper, mate. Casper Van Dien. Who's
can
he?
Can make him a friendly ghost?
Yeah, originally, but then I said Casper Van Dien, who I think was in, like, Sleepy Hollow.
I don't know.
He's in Starship Troopers.
Right.
Tarzan and the Lost City, Mortal Kombat Legacy, Beverly Hills 90210.
In all the big ones.
What filmography?
He wasn't in Sleepy Hollow then. Damn. I fucked it.
Oh, wait, he was.
Oh, he was.
He was in Sleepy Hollow. Man, there we go. Redeemed.
We'll make it clap.
The head is still part of the body, though.
We'll make it clap.
Not in Sleepy Hollow, it's not. Not fucking Ichabod Crane.
I haven't seen it. I don't know what's...
Well, it's not a film, is it? It's the legend of Sleepy Hollow. It's a book.
Well, I haven't read it.
But they made a film out of it.
I haven't seen that.
With Christopher Walken.
Oh, yeah.
And the guy who played Odo in Deep Space Nine. Oh, I can't wait till the Patreon episode we can talk about comedy.
Yeah.
Oh, I did a gig. Did I tell you, I think.
Yeah.
In a theatre with not many people in. And the MC was like, it was bad to watch. It was like watching your dad get battered.
Oh, no.
It was really sad, but like horrible at the same time. Yeah. Oh, it was grim. We'll chat about it on the page. Sign up for the Patreon. Free dabs. At least free dabs. You get loads of things. We'll do a shout out on the next one. Shout out Amanda Kidd, who up to the big dog today. Some merch coming your way.
Yeah, respect.
Respeezy, yeah. Mate. Respeezy. Have you got anything you want to bring to the table, Rob? Now that you're part of the show.
I was just bringing good vibes.
Here. Come and sit here and argue with me.
I thought that was the point, wasn't it? That was what I was brought
point
in.
Point scoring. That's all you're here for.
That's it. Can we just put a tally chart on that wall for arguments I've got right?
One nil. That's only because I don't trust the opinion of Ricky Wilson.
Yeah, but also medical expert Sid.
Oh, yeah. Sid the kid.
And slightly drunk woman Rachel Fairbairn. Yeah,
shout out Rachel.
That one don't count if she's slightly drunk.
Also, I think you're right, Mubs. I think I should have worded it better.
Yeah, well, you had the choice of how you worded it. That's
can your
you,
brain right? leave your body? That wasn't a
literal thing I was saying, though. That was, you know, the idea that my consciousness had left my physical self.
You should have said,
I had transcended.
You should have said mine then, because the brain is an actual tangible organ.
Well, sorry, I was just using a fucking analogy. I was just trying to talk about Steve Davis's DJing career. I didn't realise it would be this deep, to be honest with you.
I wonder if Davo's got anything on spot.
I didn't realise I was under fucking subpoena.
I wish we could ask Steve Davis about it.
Yeah, let's bring Steve Davis.
Mate, I wish that we were like big enough that we could just ring Steve Davis.
No, man, it'd be fucking amazing. If anyone watching or listening knows Steve Davis, get him in touch. He's welcome on the pod.
Do you reckon Ainsley knows Steve Davis?
Ainsley Harriet?
Yeah.
Yeah, I reckon they must have crossed paths at some point. They're the same sort of like celebrity strata.
Nah.
I reckon they'll have been on summit together at some
point.
Are
you saying that Steve Davis is the Ainsley of snooker players?
Some of the Ainsley of snooker players would have a really big queue that they do like this.
And he wouldn't use reds, he'd use tomatoes. Yeah. There'd be a fucking mess when he's finished it. When he smashed the onion against the tomatoes. All the pockets are little onion bags. Be like that picture of that anatomical face that's all veg. Yeah. What else would you use? What would be the brown? Sprout? A sprout would be the green.
It'd have to be a gone-off sprout for brown. All right, for brown, a little Christmas pudding.
No. It's veg. It's very veg-based. If the reds are tomatoes, like...
A potato.
Just
be a potato.
A Jersey Royal.
Blue's going to be a problem.
Still got the mud on it, so it's proper brown.
Yeah. Like, blue's going to be your issue. What's a blue veg?
Blue veg.
I don't know if there are any blue veg. I don't think blue occurs a lot in nature.
So there's this like yam they have in the Philippines. It's actually dark purple.
Yeah, purple potato.
Yeah, yeah.
It's sell not blue, them though, in is the it? Whole food chat, or whole food market.
There's not a purple ball, mate.
No, there's not.
It's blue.
It's sort of blue, isn't it? Like blueberries are kind of purple. But
so you could use a blueberry.
It's too small, mate. The scale of the game is all
off. I'm not talking about... Yeah, but all the tomatoes will be different sizes if we're using proper veg.
At least like a tomato and an onion and a potato, they're all in the same realm of size. And a blueberry is an entirely different size category, I would posit.
So you give it more points, innit?
You know what makes it extra difficult?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. More than five, that, for the mini blueberry.
What's going to be black?
Oh.
Just a burnt orange. Yeah.
An off is something
there. Aubergine or something? If you can find like
again,
a...
stop being obsessed with purple.
And like an aubergine is not the right shape.
No, very much.
Aubergine, that.
An avocado.
Oh.
You could do an avocado.
That's dark green.
But like, you know, you get them dark enough, they look black.
Nah.
They do.
This is very tenuous, this.
Oh, sorry, this was the tenuous bit.
Yeah.
That was the bit that was a stretch, was it? Because up till then, it was fine.
No, I meant the whole snooker.
The whole snooker veg bit has gone too far.
Culinary snooker.
I was just making a pepper pot gag. Again, didn't realise it had gone this far. I didn't know what I was beginning.
We'll do it when Ainsley's on, man. Yeah. He's going to come on, innit? I'm sure you'll run into him eventually.
I better add. You know what? Before we started the pod, I feel like I saw him all the time.
Oh, he's avoiding you now.
Maybe he knows. Maybe he does listen.
Yeah. Does Ainsley have a pod?
You'll be good vibes, man.
Only a pea pod.
That's what you should call it. Ainsley's pea pod.
Ainsley's pea Poddington pea pod.
Yeah.
And it's just Poddington him and loads, is, loads of dolphins.
Poddington Pea is one of the best theme tunes of all time.
Nah.
Love it. Down at the bar, the garden.
We've done it.
Among the birds.
Episode
and the
bees. 9 or something.
Well, I wasn't fucking here. I don't give a shit.
The same people are listening.
It's 2.0, mate. It's Damn Daniel 2.0.
Yeah, season 3, mate. Regen. This will go on the list.
It's the regen.
If you see season 1 on that list, then it's not even better than Fleabag, but fucking season 3, we out here. Season 1 is very much that season of The Simpsons where they all look weird.
Yeah, they're still working it out, you know. First season of Parks and Rec, they haven't quite got the characters right.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. We're here now. Yeah, we're First season of Always Sunny's meant to be like that, isn't it?
It is a bit. It's before Frank arrives, Danny DeVito's character. It's good. The first season's really good, but it, like, flies after that. Like.
Hopefully that's what's going to happen with this ting.
Already is doing, man.
Yeah, we're flying
fly out
more,
here.
Mate. I want to fly like an eagle.
I'm like fucking Dunstan on a bean.
Or Ainsley on a bean. Romeo Dunstan. bringing it up to date. You got 21 seconds to fall.
Right. What are we doing?
I want to... We've got one thing on the board, right?
Oh, yeah, shit. It's been on there for like a fucking month.
And also, since we're talking about Christopher Reeves...
Yeah.
Who is Superman?
Yeah,
and then didn't that was the horrible misleading article that they were making Superman buy?
Oh yeah, but it's just he's got to buy son.
Mm.
Yeah, it's and weird, I'm not that, talking about a big yak.
Or he just said farewell to his kid.
Yeah, like it's this big thing of like, oh, Superman's gay, or they're making everyone gay. He's just got a bi son. Mm. And like, there's no reason for his son not to be bi, is there? Like, yeah, he's super, like, surely that's a bit of a superpower.
Also, if you
being like into everyone, that's
if you've
great.
Played Street Fighter, you've also been impressed by that at one point because you've gone, bi son.
Yeah, no, I think, like, you know, like, it's just, it's amazing the things that people get annoyed by. It's like, were you going to buy that comic anyway? Like, just...
Well, not now.
It's not now. Not, not, not bloody now. Not with that filth in it.
I wouldn't even...
One of the colourists left, didn't he?
Did he?
He left because he was like, oh, this isn't what...
He was gayest as well as colourist.
He didn't have enough. He didn't have enough rainbow colours.
He's like, right, I'll do it, but I haven't got, for me crayons.
Yeah, I haven't got indigo and violet.
At the moment, what difference have you all give Barlin?
They shouted, I need indigo and violet. And one of Jacob Rees-Mogg's kids turned up.
But he's mad, man. Like, I just don't get how people have the energy to be this upset by shit. Like, who gives a fuck?
Yeah, no one's even like, do you know what? I have more sympathy for people who get mad that they get cold called and like free papers posted through the door. You know that anger that you see on the left? No free papers, no fucking junk mail. Yeah. Like, at least I understand that because they're coming into your house and putting it through
putting
your fucking letterbox.
Into your house, yeah.
Otherwise, like, just switch it off, mate.
There are so many different options of things you can, like, for entertainment. Now, there's never been more. Like, being, like, complaining about something you've watched or seen or read or not even in this case.
You know what? I can
so
even
insane.
Understand, like, points of view in the 70s when there was three channels or whatever. And it's like, look, I have to watch this at fucking 9 o'clock on a Thursday. And it's shit. But now...
No, just turn it off.
Just put Dave Jarvu on.
Yeah, if you're bored or upset by something you're watching, it's your
fault. Dave Jarvu is another one of Jacob Rees-Mogg's kids.
He's got another one called QI box set. Yeah, like I've got no fucking time for those complaints. The same people who are like, you know, like, ah, oh, they're remaking Home Alone. Well, just don't watch it then if you don't like it. It does look shit, the remake of Home Alone. It does look bad.
This as well,
making
though.
Aisling B do an English accent. Just let her be Irish.
Aisling in it.
Yeah, which, you know, fucking great for her. But they're making her do an English accent and it's bad. Like, just let her be Irish. What's the problem with that?
It is weird, that, isn't it?
So weird. Stop getting actors to do another accent.
You must
cast
be aware
with that,
that
accent, or just have them have their own accent.
You must be aware that people travel. It's not like she's from Mars. It's not Mork and Mindy where you're like, oh shit, he's weird. And he's from Mars or wherever he's from. Yeah. Like, the people from Ireland are famously in America.
Yeah.
Loads of them.
Yeah.
It will be fine.
It's just weird. They've, like, when they're writing it, like, oh, she's English, and then just cram her into it. And, like, you know, I think she's fucking brilliant, but I think she's very much hamstrung by having to do this fucking accent, you know.
Do you remember Points of View?
I do, mate. It was great. Do you remember when Terry Wogan wore gold trousers and you could see the entire outline of his dick?
No.
Mate, he wore, like, gold trousers. If you type it, like, if you Google Terry Wogan's dick, this will definitely come up.
I'm not Googling that.
Mate, when he was tight trousers on Points of View, and, like, honestly, you could see, like, mate, you could see the veins.
Bro,
it's that
packing.
Tight. Yeah, look, man, this is it. He's bringing the heat. Well, not anymore.
Terry Wogan. Terry Swolgun.
Yeah, man. Check it.
It's like he's got a ferret up there.
Yeah, it is, mate.
I don't know. Fair fucks, Terry Wogan, isn't it?
I think you've more than a few fair fucks.
Mate.
I'm going to put this on. It's from, I don't know why it's on. It could be shit, but it's Points of View from... 1992, the 11th of January.
Oh, yeah.
So if Points of View was basically, that's Deliveroo Points of View, which it's a gigs bar.
acknowledge a surprisingly large and angry response.
So that's Anne
program,
Robinson.
Intended, God. No doubt, to provide nothing more than light entertainment, or, as the publicity blurb says...
Ordinary people are the stars of a new 12-part series where they are caught in the act, usually doing something comic, which is gleefully recorded on videotape.
This sort of thing.
So this is like a You've Been Framed... So that's they threw,
hats in the air and one of them landed on the
clips, such as the one you've just seen, introduced by comedian.
They'd knock her out though.
There are also
like the standard for funny clip was much lower.
Oh, caught in the act with Shane Ritchie.
You're a visionary song contesty sort of feel. And what do you think of it so far?
Rubbish.
Several viewers refer to other versions of the same idea and indeed consider the format more suited to satellite cable or ITV. Richard Porteous of South West London, having recorded what he calls his...
acute embarrassment on behalf of the BBC for being responsible for broadcasting not partial, but total rubbish. One could consider the argument that competition for J. Beadle Esquire is required, nauseous as he is.
J. Beadle Esquire!
Nauseous as he is!
Some half-hearted attempt at a more innocent and less exploitative version.
But despite all that and more, the show is currently being watched by 12 million viewers. Elsewhere,
mate,
those
viewer numbers were mad
back being
then.
Served have returned in the evening of their years
million.
In grace and favour. The company's pension fund has been plundered. And
12 million.
That's like FA Cup final numbers, man.
Now, yeah.
That's crazy. 12 million watching that shit. It's because, like, but like, there are that What's many on? People still watching that stuff, but we all watch it on Reddit.
Yeah.
And, like,
yeah.
Instead,
What's
yeah.
on at the minute?
What do you mean?
What's
like a popular program?
Like, is Bake Off's not on?
Bake Off's on at the moment. Yeah, it is.
Can you have a look how many people watch the...
I chose Giuseppe for my team when I'm competing against my missus and he's smashing it, mate.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, Giuseppe's killing it.
Is he a puppet?
He looks like it, man. He proper looks like a doll.
Has he got a felt mouth?
Mate, a felt mouth.
So it says here, this article's from 22nd of September this year. Total of 11.5 million viewers with consolidated ratings.
Right, so it's consolidated ratings is with the catch-up as well.
Right, yeah.
So
yeah,
that's
yeah.
after a month with catch-up, 12 million.
But Bake Off's the biggest show on TV at
exactly,
the moment,
right?
It's like, moved, though, isn't it? To, like, a different channel.
Yeah,
channel
no, four. It's been on four for a while, though, and it's still, like, as okay, big. Okay. So that's, like, one of the biggest shows on
yeah, that
telly.
That was Shane Ritchie's caught in the act.
Some shit that was on. It's amazing, isn't it?
What else is on?
That's
I don't watch TV, I don't know.
Yeah, like I don't watch regular TV. I just watch catch-up shit.
How many people watch, like...
X Factor.
No, like Tipping Point.
Right.
She's a similar...
similar level of shit, yeah. Well, like, I'm going to guess that's under 2 mil, Tipping Point.
Yeah, easy.
Gotta be. I'd be a bit depressed if it was more than that. The questions on Tipping Point are insulting. They're properly like, which one of these is an animal? Is it a tree, a hat, or a dog?
Is the head a part of the body? I'd have lost
You'd
my
be getting no tokens,
lost my
man.
Tokens,
I'd be getting
mate.
Double tokens on that. I would have buzzed in and stolen.
Oh, no.
I can't get viewing figures for that one.
Yeah, they don't even release them.
Yeah, it's probably that shit.
Yeah.
Can you get the TV schedule for Friday night?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's see what. Let's see.
Let's see what it is. Because I'm interested now.
Friday night. Oh, that's today, isn't it?
That is today, yeah.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Oh, with it. So what time are we saying is night? Like 7?
Yeah,
that's peak.
All right, so then we've got The One Show, Question of Sport, EastEnders.
Let's have a look at the viewing figures for Question of Sport.
How is a Question of Sport still going, man? Like, that is the bottom end of the panel shows. It is awful.
I used to love it when I was a kid.
Yeah, again, me too, but my standards
when
were much
When it was,
lower.
Who was Bill Beaumont? Yeah. And... someone else, can't remember who the other... Ian Botham.
Yeah, but Beefy did it for ages.
Beefy? Is he your boy, is he?
Yeah, my boy Beefy.
Did you take that picture of him?
I did, mate, yeah. I love it, man. Like, there's nothing I find funnier than I got hacked just after someone's tweeted the dick.
Yeah.
Like, no, you didn't. How did the person who hacked you get a picture of your dick then?
Yeah.
Because, like, you could tell that was Ian Botham's
Saying that,
dick.
Though,
like,
yeah,
if you
yeah.
showed me that dick, like, without any context, you're like, whose dick is that? I'd be like, that is Ian Botham.
It looked like it had just been run out.
Mate, it looked like it had just put in a battling 80 on the subcontinent.
It was definitely a dick that was trying to avoid the follow-on.
Yeah, man. That dick was lethal against spin, honestly. Like, had a bit of reverse swing.
Oh... So the Question of Sport one, there was actually an article done 4 days ago about the viewing figures. So it said that while Sue was a presenter.
Sue Barker.
So they averaged between 4 and 5 million.
That's right. Well more than I thought though.
Well, what do you think it's at now?
It is
two.
Fuck. For prime time on Friday, that is
That's
bad,
isn't it? So who's the host now? Is it Phil Tufnell? Have they moved him up? That's what they normally do, isn't it? Or is it like, maybe, I feel like that's a job for Claire Balding.
It says Paddy McGuinness.
Oh, fucking God.
What is that guy doing on TV all the time?
It is mad.
He's your boy, mate.
He used to play with like my mum and my uncles and them when they were kids. They lived in the same street.
Oh, really?
I used to play with Pete Doherty when I was a little kid.
Did you?
Yeah, man, on an army base. Like,
what?
Yeah, man. Like, my dad was in the army, wasn't he?
No.
Leeds, I don't know. Different world,
yeah, my dad was in the army. I lived on an army base when I was a little kid.
I thought he said you didn't know who he was.
Yeah, but like, before he fucked off.
So he hasn't fucked off, he's AWOL.
Yeah. But yeah, we got a tapestry by Pete Doherty's mum in our house, like, that she like sewed. And my mum didn't realise until I was like a Libertines fan. And then one day she like screamed from downstairs. Because his mum was on telly. She's like, that's Jackie. And I was like, what? She's like, that's Jackie. Like, my mate Jackie. And she was like, Little Pete. And she like put it together.
Yeah. He's not Little Pete now.
Nah, man, he's a big old chunker. And good to see. I'm glad he's looking rosy-cheeked and healthy.
Because if there's ever a pointer that someone's not on the smack.
Exactly.
It's the fact that he's got a paunch.
Yeah, so good on him. He's on the big breakfast instead of the...
instead of the brown.
Instead of the crack.
Instead of the brown sauce.
Yeah. Yeah, do you reckon he's not even allowed brown sauce? He was that much of a smackhead. No. He's got, I've read.
Yeah, it's mad once because I remember in McDonald's he wanted a bacon roll with red sauce, but they give him with the brown sauce, and then he wrote "Can't Stand Me Now," and that's what he meant when he's "You fucked it up and blamed it on the brown." That's what it was. It was HP all along.
Blamed it on the world. Is that lyric?
Blamed it on the brown, innit?
Not blamed it on the brown. No.
This could be my second.
The boy kicked out of the world. World kicked back.
Yeah, he blamed it on the brown. The boy kicked out of the world. The world kicked back. This could be. I could equalise here.
I'm not getting that attached to it.
You know you got it the wrong way round.
Yeah.
What's the lyrics, Mubs?
Can't stand me now.
Yeah.
I can't remember that one line. You might
shook me up and blamed it on the brown.
Boom! Equaliser tings, yeah?
Equalizer.
That is an equaliser!
I haven't phoned four people trying to get a fucking
I'll
corroboration.
I'll phone fucking Ricky Wilson right now.
It's like this fucking idiot again.
I will fucking ring Ricky Wilson and ask him the lyrics to a better band's songs. Yeah. Oh, right.
How did we get to that?
We were talking about...
You were talking about Little Pete. Right?
Oh, yeah. No, but like, yeah, you were saying you played with who?
Oh, Maddie Paginis.
Yeah.
Maddie Paginis, yeah. See, you know what else is on tonight? I hate this fucking show. It used to give me anxiety when I was a kid because I knew I had school the next
Poirot.
Day.
Poirot?
Nah, Heartbeat.
Heartbeat, yeah.
As soon as that theme tune came on, I had to have a bath after that show.
Heartbeat. And now I spend my Sunday afternoons with green grass.
Yeah. Why do you miss when my baby kisses me? Shit, though, wasn't it?
There's a Frank Zappa documentary on tonight as well.
Oh, I'm busy washing my hair. Yeah.
You might be working then. It's at 9.
Yeah, I'll definitely be cutting it up. Oh, no, I'd have been done. I'd dusted by then.
All right.
We'd be in here doing the sound clash.
Oh, are you doing that today? Definitely.
I don't know. Maybe. Khaled wants to do it, and he's at Alexander's. Mm. So, I feel like...
Khaled.
Yeah. Khaled, shout out Khaled Winter.
Yeah,
currently
sure,
digging up some stuff. Can't
even enter the winter.
Oh shit! What is that?
That's from it's a Wu-Tang,
isn't it? Yeah. Isn't it? No, I'm joking. I was just trying to start another argument then.
Look, Ricky doesn't want to answer these questions.
Ricky knows nothing about Wu-Tang, mate.
Or the body.
Or the body.
He knows loads about the body.
No, he doesn't.
No.
He used to be a doctor.
Hey, Ricky Wilson.
Yeah, he's not a doctor now though.
No,
yeah, but he used to be.
Lost his qualification.
Yeah, he needs to go back uni, innit? He doesn't even know about precious stones, other than the red one.
He didn't used to be a doctor, by the way. I just made that up.
Oh, did he?
Just made it up.
Oh, I had you there. I thought he was the Paul Sinner of music.
Tell you what, I convinced...
Who is the Paul Sinner of music?
I don't know. There must be a former doctor.
Do you know Paul Sinner's in a Biggie track?
Yeah.
Yeah? Paul Sinner, the opposite of a winner. Remember when I used to eat sardines for dinner? And there's another one. There's do you remember Ray Kane? Gonzo Kane, aka Ray Kane. He's in a Wu-Tang song. When it's I blow so fat. Yo, Ray Kane, come in and blow off your headphones. Me and Kai used
Callie Beaton's in that as well, from Cali to Texas.
Oh yeah, shit. Yeah. Me and Kai Humphrey, shout out Kai. We used to do things where if we did comedians in rap songs, we'd tweet them.
Yeah.
Here's another one. So dumb, this as well. It's not even worth it, but I love it. Right, is it in? I think it's in Soul Food. Which is a fucking tune, by the way. In fact, we'll play us out with this. Thanks for listening to the...
Daniel Butters.
Episode 57. Say bye, Rob.
Bye.
Say bye, Mubs.
In a bit.
See if you can hear the comedian from Liverpool that lives in Leeds in this... in Jadakiss's bars. Who's the second guy? This is just for the guys that have said not enough hip hop. Fuck you to the people that said too much hip hop. Rest in piss. Yes, I'm just more soul food than eye candy. I feel like these young niggas need more eye jammies. More passport stamps, less trips to Miami. Yeah, bro, we all need a little culture. A little time away from bird-ass niggas and vultures. I tell you what you need to hear, not trying to insult you. I'm too old to kid you, I gotta adult you. Listen, this shit is getting out of hand like fumbles in football. I humbly put y'all in y'all fucking place. That's my OCD. I give a bitch a little bit, but it's mostly D. I be in that road. Royce knocking go CD. That's a supreme clientele. All I know is buy and sell. We had to hustle to eat. It wasn't no Thanksgiving. Pour out a little liquor for homies that ain't living. It's big dinner shit, baby. Everybody up in here. Find what you bring to the table. Then pull up a chair. Yeah. You see? Without hope, it ain't nothing. I like this shit. You should love it. Let's finish the game, Billy. Do something and stop stalling, that's silly. The ball over there just drawling, that's Philly. Invisible set, F-class, that's chilly. Life is short, death's fast, that's illy. When your whole crew got cash, that's willy. To everybody living it up, you gotta feel me. And nah, I ain't giving it up, you gotta kill me. Whoever you look up to, ask them, I'm a real G. Far as this rap shit go, I got a real T. Before being signed to a major, I had a real key. Now I ain't trying to play you, I'm trying to give you the real me. Almost 20 years in the game and I'm still me. Niggas fear hearing my name. I got skills, B. The boy, the girl, the weed, I got pills, B. Many other owners, you know, that's in the field, B. No license or registration, that's what it still be. Honors in your pocket, your heart, that's what it will be. From the hood, cop out, even if not guilty. Rich ain't good enough, nigga, I'm not filthy. I'm hardcore, rough and rugged, I'm not silky. Guns under mattress, money is what it will be. This is the last supper here. Last time we break bread, so pull up a chair. It's in the last line.
Fucking hell. That was a long way around to that one.
It's a tune, though.
Yeah, it's a good tune, yeah.
I'm hardcore, rough and rugged. I'm not silky. And guess who texts me just as it was on?
Silky.
Yeah!
Hey, shout out, Silky.
Shout out, Silky, man. He's not called Silky Man. That sounds like...
Yeah, Silky Man.
It's a terrible superhero.
Horrible superhero. Oh, God, Silky Man's here.
Oh, Silky Man. Get off me with your gossamer. Right, I'm going.
Do you reckon that's what Spider-Man's called in, like, Korea?
What?
Silky Man?
Silky Man. It might be Gossamer Boy.
Yeah.
Or, like, what is... No, it's called... It's, like, what's... Aranye? It was called like a Ranye man in Spanish or whatever it is. Ranye,
yeah. Isn't that what Kanye just changed his name?
It's called Hombre Araña.
Hombre Araña!
That's so
Hombre
cool.
Araña!
Yeah, I know the Japanese one's called Spider-Man.
Spider-Man?
Yeah.
That's just them saying it wrong.
But that's what a lot of Japanese, isn't it? Like, right. They call hot dogs hotter dogoos. That's true, bro.
We make it clap. We make it clap.
That is definitely what this episode's being called now.
Look, yeah. I'm not lying, am I?
Oh, that's amazing. Yeah.
Can you put... Oh, you can't do it through there, but...
Oh, yeah, you can't make it... Like, you can do it on your phone. Mm. You can get Google Translate to speak it out. And, like...
Oh, yeah.
It'd be good for this episode if it's named after something right at the end after what you've just done with the silky thing.
Try again.
Hot
dog. Does that go through earphones?
Hot dog.
Yeah.
You actually said it like less stereotypically Japanese than the computer did.
Hot dog is what people want when they're in the wrong car parks. Right, that's it. Thanks for listening to the
Dan Daniel podcast.
Or in Japanese, the Dama Daniel podcast-a-roo. We'll see you again. Take care.